When we sponsor England, so do all our customers. Nationwide, 14 million proud sponsors of the England team.
What a game in store domestically on Saturday at Eastlands. Manchester City with Rubinho against Chelsea, the side he could have gone to. Saturday from 4 o'clock, results service there, 5.30 kickoff on Santander Sports 1. Then on Monday night, we have another offering for you from the Barclays Premier League. That's Tottenham against Aston Villa from White Hart Lane. And then Tottenham are also in action in the UEFA Cup on Thursday night. That's at 7.30 against Wisla Krakow. If you want to subscribe to any of that action, press your red button now if you're not already on board, or visit our website, satanta.com, or call us on 08712 003322 or 0818 20 30 40 if you're in the Republic of Ireland. A little short of 40,000 will be inside the Maximir Stadium tonight, home of Croatia's most successful domestic side, Dinamo Zagreb. But tonight it's transformed into the stage for World Cup qualification, and everyone's got a different opinion on the outcome of this game.
Very, very important. 2-0 other day against Andorra. Can't take that in perspective. Tonight is the match.
Quietly confident. I think, you know, Croatia's built themselves up quite a lot just lately. I think, you know, they're not as good as what they think they are.
If we lose, we've got to keep our heads again, but I think it'll put a lot of pressure on the England team and Capello, you know, really make it tough for him.
We've got the players to win, so I think we should have a good chance. It's just if Capello finally gets the, hopefully gets the ingredients right.
Got to go all out for the win, that's what I say. No point going for the draw. Got to go forward, attack. 2-0, I reckon.
If we lose 2-0 here, we've got to win 3-0 at home. And if we lose 2-0 here, then are our chances that good of winning 3-0 at home?
It'll all be decided on goal difference if that were the case. Well, 2 years ago here in Zagreb, there was no Steven Gerrard, and Frank Lampard held fort in the centre of midfield. Tonight, it'll be the same again. England feel they've suffered enough at the hands of Croatia, but does that mean the team is out for revenge?
Well, it shouldn't do, really, because the important thing is the points in this group. I think points in past groups don't mean anything now. That's done and dusted. I just think now it's a case of not thinking about revenge and these things, but more about taking lessons from where we went wrong last time. It was a very strong atmosphere. I wouldn't call it hostile, a good atmosphere to play football in, but I think we need to be ready for that. And we need to try and make sure we don't make any mistakes like we did last time. And then hopefully if we put in the performance we know we can with the players we've got, we can get the result we need.
Clearly on paper, Frank, it's the toughest game of this qualifying group for England. How good are Croatia, do you think? How tough a challenge do you face here?
Well, they're very good. I saw the rankings the other day. I don't always take too much in the rankings, but they're fifth in the world. They performed in the Euros, I think, as we knew in England how they would perform. I think a lot of people, when we got beat by them, said, you know, we got beat by Croatia, you never should do. But they showed that they're a very technically gifted team. A lot of their players are now coming into England and into Europe and playing at the highest level. Like we've seen Modric come, and there's others that come and do very, very well. And I think it's you have to give these teams respect now. And it will be a very tough game for us, and we need to be ready for it.
Would you accept then, given all that, a draw? If I offer it to you now?
No, I wouldn't. I hate to think of us, an England team, with the quality we've got coming away here and being happy for a draw. I think once you have that in your mind, it's the wrong attitude to take. We should go and want to win, and we do go and want to win. Of course, after the event, you can always look back and say, well, that was a good result, if it was a draw or a win or whatever, depending on the circumstance of the game. But going into it, the players we've got, we have to be going for a win, for sure.
How do you feel personally you've played for England in the last couple of seasons?
I think I probably feel, if you ask any of our players, the same. I don't think I've performed as well as I can do for England. You know, it's been very difficult for us as a group, because I think we all feel the same, and we're all pretty honest about that. I think, you know, we do take a lot of criticism at times, but when you come into the camp, it's us criticising ourselves. We know we want to do well for England, we want to play very well, and we know we haven't performed as well. So for me, and I think for the team, it's a case of really trying to turn it around now, show what we can do, play the way we play for our clubs, play as a group, play as a team, and qualify for the World Cup.
What's your impressions of Fabio Capello? Have England progressed under him, do you feel?
Well, I think we're progressing. We're certainly progressing behind the scenes, and hopefully that will come to fruition more on the pitch. It's not going to be an overnight thing. I think confidence was low as a group, having not gone to the Euros. I think as a country, in football terms, it was low. And that's not easy, I think, for a manager to come and pick up. It's not easy for the players to just turn that around in a second. One thing for sure is that we're trying everything. The manager's come in with some new ideas, a very strong winning mentality, which we all know from his record from before. And hopefully it will come together and move us further forward.
He got very angry with Joe Cole and Wayne Rooney. He admitted as much after the game during the second half. Is he quite a fearsome manager to work under? He clearly is very animated on the touchline. Is he something that's very different to what you've experienced before with England?
No, well, with England maybe. I think I wouldn't say fearsome is a word. He's very determined and very strong in his views, and he puts them across. I think people can make too much of that. You know, you see headlines the day after the game that about him having a go at Wayne Rooney and Joe Cole. I think he was just trying to put over something tactically. It's a lot of, when managers have not done that kind of thing in the past for England, people have said that they should be doing it. So I think we should just be happy with the fact that the manager's putting across his views in the way he wants, and the players are responding. There's no one that sort of is too big to get a bit of stick in the camp. We all want to go further forward, and the manager wants to get his point across.
You're used to dealing with expectation, Frank, but it seems over the last couple of years you've become something of a target of England fans' frustrations with the side's performances. Can you explain why you feel that is?
I don't know. Maybe it comes from the World Cup. It was a difficult time for me. As I say, I went into it with a lot of expectations on me, a lot of expectations on myself, and it didn't quite go right for me. And from then on, I've just tried to work as hard as I can for England. And every time I come, every time I play, I try and play as well as I can. Fans will get frustrated with many things, I think, as we've seen recently. And I think they have the prerogative to do that. As a footballer, and I think the more experience you get, the more easy it is to realise that you just have to go through that. If you start letting that affect you on the pitch, it becomes detrimental to you as a player and the team. That's why when the England players call for the fans to support the team, we're not trying to have a go at the fans or have a go at the right that they've got to have opinions on the game. We're just saying as a group that we can work better together with support. I think it showed in Andorra. There were times when the fans were getting frustrated. We were getting frustrated more than anyone, going in at 0-0 at half-time. When we came out, they lifted, we lifted, and we went on and got the result we needed. So, you know, fans are always entitled to opinions. It's no problem. We have to concentrate on winning football matches.
Some would say briefly that if you tried your best for England and yet you've come off, you've been substituted as you were against Czech Republic and received some boos, you'd be tempted to perhaps walk away from England. Has that ever crossed your mind?
No, it hasn't, because I love playing for my country. And I think for quite a few caps now, whenever I can, I'll come and play for my country. I'll play for my country in any circumstances I can do. And I'm very proud to do so as an Englishman. And I think that's something that hopefully when I'm older and I look back at my career, I can look back and be very proud that when I've been picked, I've given my all. And I'll continue to do that for as long as I can. And, you know, feeling just turned 30, I don't feel like it's time for me to stop, far from it. I want to be part of a successful team because, as I said before, like the other players that are frustrated with how we've performed in the last couple of years, we want to show that we can do something and we can make a bit of history. And as a group, and as a person, I'll be trying to do that.
Frank Lampard will be in the middle of the park this evening, but just confirmation that Theo Walcott does play instead of David Beckham, who is on the bench. Experience is something you've all talked about, and is it a gamble to put Walcott on then?
We'll let you know after the game. I mean, he came on, he played the other day against Andorra, he looked sharp. He gives you something different than David Beckham. We all know David Beckham's delivery is second to none. But Theo Walcott is probably more offensive, which says great things for Fabio Capello's selection tonight. He's not scared. He's going to go out. He's going to be positive. So I think it's a positive selection, without a doubt.
Solidity maybe elsewhere in the team, Sam, do you feel?
Well, if you look at the back four, I mean, you know, it's fantastic, isn't it, defensively? I mean, it should be able to cope with most of what the Croatian players throw at them tonight if they're all on song. And they've played together for so long. It's two Man United players, two Chelsea players playing together. So there shouldn't really be a problem there defensively. And that might give the opportunity for Theo Walcott to get some good possession. He's got to be fed the right sort of service if he's going to expose or try and use his pace, as Fabio seemed to put him in for. Maybe what he thinks England's lacking a bit of is pace on the front line, and Theo Walcott could give him that. And then, of course, the quality of the cross from both sides, from Joe and Theo, is going to be very important for Mieleski, Wayne Rooney, Frank Lampard arriving late.
Without the likes of Theo Walcott, do you feel that England are a bit one-paced, a bit slow, Terry?
I wouldn't say they're slow. We haven't had as much pace as we would like, and Walcott solves that problem. But I look at that, and like Sam, you say, well, the back four is terrific. We've got Barry and Lampard in the middle. Neither of them are really a specialised holding player. So they'll both do a bit of each. So I think that's a really attacking team to come here with that. Nothing wrong with that, because that's what we need. They'll have to defend that midfield as a four. So you don't say you stay and then the others go after that. And you've got Cole, Walcott, Eske and Rooney for counter-attacks, because we will be under pressure. And we will be looking to really springboard out and make the most of it. And that's where I think. Set pieces, and I think the counter-attack is what we're geared up. Frank Lampard breaking as well. But they must defend well as a group when they're under pressure, because the back four will have to take everything.
OK, let's get Dan Rowe to take us through the complete team news. Dan.
Thanks, Angus. Well, as you say, the big news is that Theo Walcott will start again, his second international. Let's take a closer look now at the rest of the England side that's been given the task of trying to get a positive result here in the cauldron that is the Maximir Stadium. Wes Brown is the first of four changes. He comes in for Glenn Johnson. Rio Ferdinand, as we know, is fit and he's back. Jolyon Lescott misses out. Joe Cole starts for the first time in five matches under Fabio Capello. Emil Heskey replaces Jermaine Defoe up front. But of course, the big news is not a change. It's the fact that Theo Walcott retains his place on the right-hand side after impressing so much. As the guys were saying in the studio, David Beckham misses out and he has to be content with a place on the bench. This is Croatia, a team, of course, that have never lost a competitive fixture here in Zagreb. A couple of familiar faces you can see there. Luka Modric in midfield and Vedran Čurluka, Tottenham Hotspur teammates. They do have injury worries, of course, though, in the shape of Nico Kranjčar and Eduardo, who miss out. But they are formidable opponents. Now, I've been joined here, pitch side, by Chris Waddle, our co-commentator this evening. Chris, it's a big call. Is he right to include Theo Walcott, do you feel?
I think it's a very positive move. I think the one thing you've got to do when you come to a place like this, atmosphere is electric already. You've got to be brave. You've got to go and have a go at them. I think if we sit back, it's not the English way. We're not sort of defending deep. We're better when we go and attack teams. And I think the pace of Walcott, because their fullbacks push on a lot, there's a lot of gaps for Rooney, Heskey, and Walcott's pace could really capitalise on that today. Very positive move.
You mentioned the atmosphere, Chris. I can tell you that home, it is absolutely kicking in this stadium, an amazing atmosphere. Will this be too white hot for Theo Walcott? Would it not have been better to play David Beckham?
You never know. He should take a lot of confidence. I know it was Andorra, but he played well for half an hour, and I think he should take that into the game tonight. We know what you're going to get from him. He's quick. And I think Slaven Bilic, when he looked at the team, he was probably expecting David Beckham, but he knows how to play against. Now he's got Walcott, and he'll be worried about his pace.
Emil Heskey comes in to start, as does Joe Cole. They obviously have been rewarded for what happened when they were brought on. Is that a good move?
I think it is. Leaves the lane well. He's mobile, strong, good in the air, great out ball. And as I say, if you get the ball up to him, he will bring players into the game.
The pitch, of course, played a role last time, the deadly divot, which did for Paul Robinson. How is the pitch, do you think, this evening?
Well, I spoke to a couple of players who have been on it already, and then they said it's very firm, very bubbly. It's not the best condition. The ball is going to be bubbling all over. More concentration today. Get your first touch right and you'll be okay.
You played in some intimidating atmospheres, Chris, around the world for club and country. How does this compare, do you feel?
This is as good as it gets. I mean, these are the games you should look forward to. England players in the tunnel, in the change room now, should be really looking forward to it. It's going to be great if England take the league, quiet this crowd, because they're very fanatical.
Chris Waddle, thank you, sir, for your thoughts. Well, I can tell you there's about 3,000 England fans in the stand that's behind us. You get the impression that England will need them. It's one of those nights where Fabio Capello's side will need all the help they can get.
It's either a great atmosphere or a terrible atmosphere. We're battling against a PA system that wouldn't be out of place at a Guns N' Roses concert at the moment, but we will battle on, and Dan battling on out there. We talk about the pitch there, and we know how difficult it was for Paul Robinson and how embarrassing it was. David James is in, you know, between the posts this evening. He didn't have, well, barely six touches at Andorra.
I put wrong Jackson's. Yeah, James full of confidence, and He's been playing like that, of course, against the Czech Republic. There was a few mistakes, but this year for Portsmouth, he's been fantastic. We saw the game against Everton the other day, saving a penalty, making world-class saves. And it's a big night for him. He'll be put under a lot more pressure than he was the other day. But it's another big test for him, and one that he should relish.
Well, there's one spot he might like to avoid tonight, and it's this one. You'll be able to see it if you remember Gary Neville's back pass, the edge of the 6-yard area. And there it was, a little bobble and over Paul Robinson's leg. It went, and England were 2-0 down. The pitches, as we said tonight, and the players are happy with it. It's quite firm. They've watered it this evening. Will England want to push it around quickly, or in a Capello way, sit on it and relax a bit if you can in an atmosphere like that?
Well, I mean, that's very much decided on the opposition and whether they're going to give you time to settle on the ball and pass it. And if that is the case, yes, do it. If it's not the case, and Chris Waddle said the pitch a little bit bobbly, we've got Emil Heskey, fantastic target man. All right, may not score the goals that people say he should, but he brings a lot of other people into the game. So if it needs tonight to play off him and then bring other people into the game, then let's do it. And let's do it well, and let's build from there. If we have got the time to play and pass it around and break the opposition down, great. If not, let's use an alternative approach, which worked so well at Wembley against Russia in the European qualifiers.
Terry, we're talking about, you know, roles for various players. You got Rooney talking about there, but how important do you feel that Rio Ferdinand being fit and coming back alongside that role with John Terry at the back?
I think it's exceptionally important. I think him and John Terry are undoubtedly as good as you'll get anywhere internationally. There's no question about that, and he's become, you know, he's got an aplomb in his game that is really what is needed. Get the ball down and play. If they're going to give us space, move that ball around. But we've got to move it around quickly, because they will come snapping. They will come in bunches of three, four and five to win the ball. So if you have an extra touch, they've got you, and we will lose it in areas which will be dangerous. Defending tonight is uttermost in our game. No mistakes. Professional efficiency. If it has to go, get it out. We play when we've got chance.
Talking about professional, efficient, John Terry, synonymous with that.
Yeah, the skipper's back, and it's great. The back four, as we're talking about, it's as experienced as we're going to get. All Champions League, they all played in the Champions League. Arguably the best around at the minute are centre-halves. And it's, I think last year, there's mitigating circumstances when we lost at Wembley to Croatia. We had a back four relatively inexperienced, as in playing with each other. We were missing the leaders that we have back tonight. So I think it's vitally important that they stand up and have a decent game. And if they have a decent game, we'll get a decent result.
We've talked about Theo Walcott in an attacking sense, Sam. Defensively, is he going to be able to provide the protection for the likes of Wes Brown and the rest of that back four?
Yes, there's no doubt about that for me. I think that He will do his very best out of possession to get back in that bank of four. It is a little worry, that four, that there's no natural defenders there to look after or try and help the England back four. But yet again, depending on the service that we give to him, it could be about their fullback trying to defend against him all the time rather than him chasing their fullback. And that's really what we want to see tonight. And I just hope it normally boils down to two things, a game like this, and that's mistakes set plays, and I think that we certainly have to cut out those mistakes we made last time we were here.
Okay. It's such an impressive record that Croatia have here in Zagreb. It's given the whole of the country massive confidence whenever the national team plays, and that's something that's been reflected in the newspapers, and Dan has been mingling with the local press.
Well, the match against England is, of course, huge news here on the streets of Zagreb and amongst the Croatian sports media. Zvonko Alac here joins me. He is a writer on the country's leading sports website. Zvonko, here's the morning's newspapers. A rather disturbing image on the front of this one. What's it
say?
Yeah,
it's a two-faced montage of Slaven Bilic and Fabio Capello, and the Bilic's half says, oh yes, and Capello's, oh no. Bilic, there's a quote of him, he says, we are confident of our strength and we are going for the third victory in a role against great opponents.
What's the mood amongst the country? Are you confident of a convincing win against England?
The country is overconfident for a victory against England.
Yes. How many goals?
I think that the general opinion is that it will be two or three goal difference for us.
No shortage of confidence after the two victories over. And what does this paper here say?
That's another Bilic's quote that says the 1 point is not enough.
So you're going for a win?
For a win.
And finally, there's a shot here of the Croatian squad training.
Yes, it's a rallying cry for victory.
For victory. Tell me, what is the view of the England squad and Fabio Capello amongst the Croatian media?
Croatian media, Croatian supporters think that Fabio Capello is a great coach and a great trainer. But on the other hand, English players, which are great on the club level, are poor on the international level when they're playing for England.
And what about the Croatian media's view of your own squad? Of course, you were beaten by Turkey in the quarterfinals of the Euro 2008 competition. Have you recovered from that disappointment yet?
Yes. The general opinion about that is that was a long time ago. Now we are facing England again, and that's the most important game of this year.
There were lots of rumours that Slaven Bilic may be leaving his job to take up a position at West Ham. We know that that's not the case now. Has that unsettled the country?
No. Everyone here knows that was just transfer rumours, which are normal for this time of year, especially in Premiership. And there is no secret that Slaven would and will one day coach a team in the Premiership.
And finally, Zvonko, I'll put you on the spot. What will the score be this evening?
I think that it will be draw 1-1 or 0-0, because we will go for a victory, and Capello will make barricades in front of the goal.
We'd be happy with that. England lost home and away against Croatia in their last qualifying campaign, but there's a new man at the helm, and he's going to do it his way.
Confidence. Yes, we have to respect Croatia, but we are young coach.
Coming weekend, we have two rugby matches from the Magnus League for you here on Setanta Sports. Leinster against Edinburgh kicks off on Friday night at 7 o'clock, our programme on 2, and then also on 2 on Sunday afternoon at 5:30. It's Munster against the Dragons. If you want to watch any of our action and you're not a subscriber, then do press your red button now or visit our website at setanta.com or call us on 08712 0033 22. Or if you're in the Republic, the number is 0818 20 30 40. The disciplinarian watches over his team. It's by far his toughest test yet for him and his players. Slaven Bilic is not the archetypical modern manager, but he knows how to motivate a team, even if that means lying on the bed with them. His words, not mine. Well, to West Ham and Everton fans, as a player, Slaven Bilic put his head in where no one else would. Now, as a manager, he's using it to mastermind a hat-trick of victories over England. Adam Dark has been trying to track down Croatia's Dragon Slayer.
We waited and waited and waited until finally word arrived. We were to cross the Slovenian border for a late night rendezvous with one of football's most unique characters. We should have known it would be like this. A qualified lawyer, a rock star, a man too cool to be a coach, but not, as I discovered, a diplomat.
Most of your players would be considered, if they were Croatians, definitely, I mean, to play for Croatia. But I wouldn't swap any of my players now for an English player.
He has the most inquisitive mind, full of calculations and theories, enigmatic, charismatic. He could be your best friend or your worst enemy.
If I was manager of England, you know, that would be my first task, to find out what is the problem. Because you can't say there's no problem there. Sometimes they're very unlucky, okay, with especially under McLaren, you know what I mean? With so many injuries and suspensions and everything, blah, blah, blah. But sometimes when they are all fit, they still don't perform. And you have a team sheet and you go like, it's unbelievable. So many good players, I mean, they should click.
And once again, he was away, considering, speculating. Don't be fooled by the earring, the lit cigarette, or the laid-back demeanor. He's passionate about team ethics and knows where England are falling short.
I heard some situations some situations from different national teams. When we were playing, we have a great atmosphere, and they told me then that in Italy it's not the same. In France, they go to their rooms and they play, I don't know what, PlayStation or Nintendo or whatsoever. But we are like this. I don't know the situation in England, but I think they're all right. But if you don't have like that, then it's pretty much harder. When it's down to pure business, it can work out, but it can't be like proper if there are no emotions. Of course, we are confident. We are playing at home. We beat them twice. We have a great, but the biggest reason why we are confident is because we were a better team now than we were in Euro, not to mention on Wembley, not to mention Zagreb 2 years ago. We are a really good team. That's what I think. We can lose. On this level, it's like all about details, you know what I mean? The game can turn, it's split second, you know, 1-0 or 0-1. It's like, but we are confident.
And with that, he was off to sleep, perchance to dream. Bilic has no cause for nightmares.
No, he just causes them. No lack of confidence.
You can see that.
Yeah. Overconfident.
Well, this is a very formidable stage, and they haven't, as Sam mentioned before, they haven't lost here, so you have to be confident. They've got a great record against England recently. You can see he's instilling this confidence throughout the team, can't you? Individually, you take the English team over the Croatians all the time, but collectively, they're doing something right, and you know, the manager's got a great way about him at the moment, hasn't he?
There's a freshness about him, yeah. Isn't there? There's an unusual... Well, it's funny when you look at it.
Of course.
It's his style, though, isn't it? Yeah. That's what I like about him. Yeah. He's not copying anybody else or trying to model himself on some of the managers he may have experienced in his career who worked successfully. It's just him. And I think, you know, the biggest part about him seems to be, you know, that personality rubbing off on his team to get rid of the sort of frailties that Terry was talking about before. He seems to have got his team to dismiss that, use the skill and ability, but also have a passion and an understanding and a team spirit together, which brings it all together, which is what it's all about, even for the England side. You know, as he says, you look at the team sheet, great players, but don't quite do the level of performance collectively that they do when they're playing for the clubs. But I think that England have to get over the hump somewhere along the line. It's like Colin Montgomery can't win a major golf tournament. England couldn't get past the quarterfinals, and that's the biggest mental problem that we have. Now it's not just that, not qualifying for the European Championships, it's making sure we qualify for the World Cup and go from there.
But it's beating a side that, or drawing with a side that, Terry, that the Bilic has put together, made them play well, qualified for major tournaments, and has got off to a perfect start in this campaign again. You know, beating Kazakhstan 3-0.
He's done very, very well. He's done very well. But there is that confidence, and there is an area of overconfidence, and he wants to throw it in your face a bit as well, which upsets the opposition. That is why I hope it's upset us enough tonight to actually really want to get one over. We've got to do that tonight. But even in the Euros, he started over-talking his team. In fact, that was, I don't know if you remember, he then started saying, we can beat these, we can beat anybody, and the next game, they got beat. Yeah. You've got to put a cap on that, because you can't win all the games from off the field. You've got to give them, instill that confidence, get them to where you want to be, and make sure they stay.
They either
go forward or go backwards. You don't stand still as a football team.
Is Luka Modric the most dangerous player on the field for
I think
England?
He's a wonderful little player. I think he's a terrific player, and I felt that for a long while. I don't like to say that I think, as an attacking player, the freedom he gets, maybe he should get more goals. I don't mean against us. I was thinking about it for Tottenham, and you know, how he will change maybe his way to try and do that. You need one of your midfield players to get a collection. But as a competitor, as a skillful player, he's a terrific player.
Okay. Well, Fabio Capello has had 9 precious days with the England squad, and he believes that each new day has brought more confidence. Tonight is a step up from Saturday. This is surely the most important match of the campaign.
I think at this moment, this is very important. All the people is focused about this game. But we think we have to play another not easy game.
Do you enjoy these big matches as a manager?
Yes, it's exciting matches, always. I prefer these matches not against Andorra, because against Andorra sometimes you can find difficulties stupid. because the level between the two teams is very, very different.
Do you have a plan to deal with Luka Modric? Because the last time England played, he was very important to them.
I know Modric now in Tottenham plays a different position, like second forward. I follow him during the Euro, and it's a dangerous player, high quality, but we have to think about Modric, about the other Croatia players, but I think it's better we have to play with confidence. Yes, we have to respect Croatia, but we are strong also.
Joe Cole has always been a talented player. He scored against the Czech Republic, he scored two against Andorra. Why have you not started with him for the last four matches?
Because he scored goal, I tried to find the space with the wide players to arrive to do the crosses. But at the second half, I changed it and I push Enski and Joe Cole because we needed some player that played in front of the goal for this season. It's a different view. Sometimes one manager decide tactically something different, but we can change during the game.
How tough will the atmosphere be in the Maximir, do you think?
I thought the Croatian supporters are very, very strong and help a lot the team, but the supporters don't play. And I'm very happy with the English supporter, and I think I hope that after the game we'll be happy.
In the last few years, England have gone to difficult places. They've gone to Rome and they've gone to Istanbul, and they've found that spirit. Is that what they need to find for this match?
Yes, I remember that England team always played very well home. Now I hope we will play tomorrow very well away, with the spirit, with courage, and without fear. This is very important to find. And in this moment, I saw the players very focused in this thing. And I'm sure tomorrow we will play well.
Well, Fabio always talks about playing without fear, yeah. And that's very much how he feels about it.
Yeah, I think
game.
He wants his players to play with a lot of confidence. You know, we said before, it's a hostile ground. They have to be confident tonight. They have to be very positive. You don't want to see England sitting back and getting further and further and defending our goal. We want to see them going forward. We want to see it taking the game to Croatia. And as I said, his team sheet is very positive. He wants Theo Walcott to go out and attack these players.
Terry, you're still worried who's going to mark Modric, aren't you?
I am, because he will get forward and he will get opportunities. You know, Frank Lampard and Barry, neither of them are the individual specialists that put someone out of the game. So this is why they've got to do it between them, and there's sometimes a moment when neither of them have got him. So that's why you want someone. He's really right through the middle, he floats, looking for spaces, and he'll give that killer ball. And he is capable of getting him right on goal. So where it's a brave midfield, it's also, it concerns me a bit there. And also they've got a left-sided player for Krankia called Rakitic. He's only 20, and he's a really good player. And Brown can do a great job stopping him tonight, because if he doesn't, that might take Walcott back as well, because he can be, when he's on fire, a good player. But like we said earlier, I think Steve said, Walcott can also go that way and yeah. Try and send their Prasnic that way.
One thing of concern, it may be of concern for England players, the pitch here through the warm-up has been cutting up a little bit, and that's in goal. We don't want to see anything like we saw last time. As Terry was saying, Sam, can there be that natural compression to actually stop Modric playing?
Well, they're going to have to. It's as simple as that. I mean, I thought at Wembley particularly, England got so many men forward that the ball popped out to Modric and he set the Croatian team on every attack that caused England lots of problems, particularly in the first half. So, you know, this time round it's different. We're away from home. If we can't do it as an individual, then we must do it as a group.
OK. Thanks, Sam. The time has nearly come. Time for England to make amends, to take revenge for an empty summer, to restore some pride to the Three Lions and to quieten the Boo Boys. Croatia against England is live next.
This is not the time for faint hearts. We have no divine right to victory at every turn, but we as a nation are infused with pride and passion, born of torches past that burn deep within. Yes, there are mountains to climb. Yes, there are rivers to cross. But this is the day to stand your ground, shoulder to shoulder, in unity as one. Is now. Through the blood, sweat, and the tears, when the blast of conflict fills the ears of the chosen few, they must stand firm, hold hard the breath, and bend up every spirit to its full height. Show us the mettle of your pasture. Let us swear that you are worth your breeding. Strain from the start, for the game has begun. Follow your spirit, and upon this charge, summon every inch of your whole being for yourselves, for England, and for St. George.
The time has come, nearly 2 years since their last visit. England are back on Croatian soil to try and lay that goal to rest. Back again in the Maksimir Stadium. To subscribe, you can press your red button now or visit satanta.com or call us on either of these two numbers. So now is the time. It may never be tougher than this for England as they continue along their journey to South Africa 2010. Pointing us in the right direction tonight, Chris Waddle and John Champion.
And as you can perhaps see, Angus, and good evening to you and to everyone, we are shoehorned into part of the Maksimir Stadium here. There's not much spare room, 37,000 screaming Croatians roaring their team on and waiting for the teams to come out. And Chris, it strikes me, Zagreb's a lovely place to visit, but it's a pretty difficult place to come and play football.
Most difficult. We've heard the atmosphere the last hour. It's building up, very fanatical fans, terrific home record. It's all up to England, yeah, it's going to be a lot of pressure, but I'm very confident.
Well, I hope that your confidence is well placed. Croatia's team rarely changes. Both system and components are well established. The pool of players is strong enough to withstand the loss to long-term injury of Arsenal's Eduardo and Portsmouth's Nico Kranjčar. One change from the side that eased past Kazakhstan here on Saturday. Their match winner at Wembley, Mladen Petric, starts in place of Ivan Klasnic.
Well, if you look at this team, Croatia, very good technically. Kovacs just sits in front of the two centre-halves. But it's Olic who really runs his socks. But it's Modric, who obviously well-known in the English league. He's the player they've got to stop. And watch for Cerna. Crosses, fantastic crosses. Good pace down the right-hand side.
Well, Steve McLaren came here 2 years ago and put out a 3-5-2 formation that infused Croatia more than his own players. Fabio Capello toyed with the idea of a three in midfield, not in defence. In the end, he's plunked for 4-4-1-1, four predictable changes. Brown, Ferdinand, Joe, Cole and Heskey all in from the start. But the headline, the retention of Theo Walcott, which means no starting place for David Beckham.
Well, I think he impressed with his pace. You play on that right-hand side. And the one thing they do, Croatia, they do leave gaps down the sides. The full-backs do push on a lot. And that's why Walcott's in the team. They're going to play a lot of balls through the gaps between the centre-halves and the full-backs. Look for Walcott, Rooney and Heskey spinning down the channels. And that's where they're going to get the joy tonight.
And so, after 10 months of soul-searching and self-analysis, England have this chance to confront their demons head-on. Their own blundering, as much as Croatia's brilliance, was responsible for the withdrawal of a coveted invitation to European football's summer party. Now, though, comes an assignment where revenge is high on the agenda and a chance to show that good players can be moulded into a good team. 2,600 English supporters. Now, the signs so far under Fabio Capello, not promising, but here's a reputation built on delivering when it really matters. And tonight, as the players emerge onto this Maximir Stadium playing area, it does matter. Lubos Michel, the vastly experienced Slovakian referee, leading the way. 2 years ago, England lost 2-0 here. And the crumbling stadium is even more decrepit now than it was then. A relic of communist austerity, no cover, basic facilities, and a pitch that can do funny things to back passes. Little wonder Croatia never lost a competitive game at home. No wonder that they've delayed time and again the intended demolition of a citadel that has yet to be stormed. Now, you may recall the gaffe with the Croatian anthem that so inspired their players at Wembley. Opera singer Tony Henry mispronouncing a key word and so extolling the virtues not of Croatia's mountains, but a delicate part of his own anatomy. Well, the first of a number of serious mistakes by the English on that fateful night, unfortunately. Here, the anthems should be rather more straightforward. Just as it was at Wembley 10 months ago, England in white, Croatia in blue. Croatia, who know they're good and have the victories to show it. England, who think they're good, but have yet to prove it. Familiar foes now, these two sides. The sixth time that they've met overall, the third meeting in the last 2 years. Bearing in mind the misfortunes to befall England's last two goalkeepers against Croatia, David James can be excused if he feels just a touch nervous. However, Theo Walcott hasn't been tainted by previous Croatian experiences. His jet-heeled display against Andorra clearly caught Capello's eye. As for the Croatians, So many threats. How will England deal, for instance, with Luka Modric, now of Tottenham, the latest to bear the mantle of playmaker, and all the more so in the absence through injury of Nico Kranjčar. And then there's Mr. Perpetual Motion, the number 18, Ivica Olic, who has led England a less than merry dance in the past. He will run and run and run. So, Chris Waddle, key things that Capello will have said to his players in the moments before they emerge from the dressing room?
Stand up and be counted. Go out there. Atmosphere's out off the pitch. It's not on the pitch. And I just think that the players have got to be very positive and play what they're good at. Go and press players. Look to get beyond. Get people in the box. Be positive.
Slaven Bilic, who we're told will not now be going to West Ham, but has prepared his side with a third victory over England very much in mind. No need for a brolly tonight, but tin hats might be useful given the surroundings and the opposition. It's a case of hold on tight for a game that will shape the mood for the season. Does the depression grow deeper, or is this the night when we finally see the fruits of Fabio Capello's expensive labours? So much secrecy surrounding England's team selection these days, but this presumably is plan A at long last. Plan A, bearing in mind that the likes of Gerrard and Hargreaves and Carrick are all injured. Now, Chris Waddle, you never lost a qualifier playing for England, but this is a real test for them tonight.
Well, it is straight away, John. Looking at Croatia, they are 4-4-1. Petric is not playing on slightly left. I thought he might have. He's playing off the striker. Olic is playing up top. Petric has dropped back into the hole. But I just like to see it. I hope the positive, a lot of confidence. You know, we've got good players. You know, you come here, and a lot of teams come here and sit back, John, and think, well, we'll just try and catch them on the break. That's what Croatia's good at. Let's cut them full send back and play the high tempo. They don't like being settled on the ball.
Now, the noise in these early moments is everything that we were told to expect of the Maximir. Intimidating, certainly, but also uplifting.
What's strange, John. We, you know, the feed we got, we're going to play diagonal balls for Walcott's pace and Heskey down the same. Rooney, they've had the ball there three or four occasions. Could have played it, played little triangles and have sniffed it out, Croatia, and they've got them high up the field.
This is Čorluka. And John Terry finds Frank Lampard. And Rooney fails to control.
People going about the atmosphere, John. Yes, it is. It's very tense. You can feel it. But, you know, these players have played Champions League. They've played everywhere now. They shouldn't be worried at all about the crowd.
Well, Capello says that he thinks the players prefer playing away from their new £800 million home stadium at Wembley. Less pressure on them. Less likelihood of being booed. Wasn't what the FA wanted to hear, bearing in mind their huge investment, but this makes some sense. Foot was high. Free kick is taken by Terry. Into the head of Kranjic. And it's not as if promotion are an unfamiliar force anymore in European or indeed world football. Just a matter of a minute or so away. and reaching the last four of Euro 2008 in the summer. Olic with the layoff to Petric. Modric now. Three up with him. Niko Kovac. And Modric is back for more. Cerna. Terry's intervention. And Walcott has lost it. And Mladen Petric has it. And Pranjic held at the second attempt.
That was a great save by Pranjic. That's what they're all about. They take the ball away from a sloppy pass from Wayne Rooney, deep in their own half. And that's Croatia within, what, 5-6 seconds on the edge of the England box. And that's what we've got to make sure Lampard and Barry sit.
Well, as you watch that replay, England have earned themselves a free kick. Pranjic, who had the effort on goal. And news of a goal in one of the other World Cup qualifiers involving a home nation. It's come in Reykjavik, where Scotland have taken the lead against Iceland through Kirk Broadfoot after 18 minutes.
This is definitely worth a shot. Frank Lampard strikes a terrific ball. Let's see if he can just hit the target. These balls fly, we know they are. It's definitely worth a pop from there.
It is Lampard, it took a deflection, it is a corner.
It's worth an effort, anything could happen. There's a lot of bodies around the box and England have won themselves a corner. And this is a big part of our game, set pieces.
Capello saw a lot of Croatia in the summer at the Euros. Didn't seem to be hugely impressed. Ashley Cole. Barry. Ferdinand. Rooney. Lampard sends it into the path of Theo Walcott, who stubs his cross. Heskey was waiting for it. And as it screwed off the outside of Walcott's boot, Heskey's made a challenge on the goalkeeper, which the referee didn't like.
Well, it just shows the pace he's got, Walcott. Lovely ball by Frank Lampard. And I don't know what really happened there. He's tried to pull the ball square to Heskey, Walcott, but that's what he's got. A lot of pace. He's going to cause Croatia a lot of problems tonight.
A surprise in the Croatian camp that Walcott is playing. They were expecting David Beckham on the right side of England's midfield. David Beckham was expecting David Beckham on the right side of England's midfield. Capello is keen to establish a meritocracy. He feels that Walcott played outstandingly well in Barcelona.
I think that's nice, John. England, for a change, are not favourites. I know a lot of supporters as they are, but tonight, Croatia favourites.
It'll be interesting to see how they wear that tag. They've been so used to upsetting the big names of world football as underdogs. Tonight they're expected to come out on top.
I think they've started very well, England. Very confident on the ball. I think they can relax a little bit more. They've got more time than what they realise, especially as they get up the halfway line. You know, enjoy it. You've got good possession. Enjoy the ball.
Down goes Heskey. England have another free kick. There is the man in question. Still marooned, one short of 100 starts for his country. And you just wonder whether the baton has passed a generation tonight from Icon to young Tyro. Bilic standing just behind Frank Lampard as he prepares to take this free kick. Now the Croatian manager has retreated back to his technical area. Lampard actual Lucas header, and then Niko Kovac. Barry. Olic.
England for me, this team, they're all over them, they're picking the second ball up. Just looking for a little bit of quality. Walcott's had the ball, two or three good positions, wasted his deliveries, cross on his final touch. It's a positive start by England.
Walcott has it again. Rose of faith from Capello could be the making of a young man, Theo Walcott. Ferdinand. Good movement from Heskey. Walcott. Just a little bit of pace to him. Heskey once more.
And that ball for England is on a lot. Rio Ferdinand. Emi Heskey's movement's excellent. He's strong. He can get people. I think Walcott's got his boots on the wrong feet so far, but hopefully he's settled down.
Lampard. Modric with the block, England throw. Wes Brown, that was out of play. Rather a waste.
If you look at Croatia, John, they haven't really got anybody up front. England's pushed them right back to the 18-yard box. And this is exact start was. Very positive team. I was very pleased to put the side out, and they've really, really pushed Croatia back already. It's a great start by England.
What a glimpse in passing there of Ivan Klasnic, who's the player to lose his place in the Croatian side tonight. Petric. Terry, Joe Cole, now Rakitic, Serna. Wes Brown has to be careful here.
He does tend to overcover Wes Brown when he plays fullback. He's a centre half naturally, and he gets too close to Rio Ferdinand.
This is Luka Modric. Up a little for Modric. Petric lucky to get a second bite. You know what that left boot can do. Walcott. Intervention by Simunic. Serna. Rakitic.
Good play by Rakitic. The late Serna lays that diagonal ball to him. Switches the play very well, but it's the first time we've really saw Croatia come over on halfway line. And I just wonder if England can keep this pace up, the tempo.
Six Croatians in the England penalty area. And David James has spilt it, and there's no whistle. And it's Chorluka, and England escape.
That's a great corner, lovely ball. Serna whips a terrific crossing, a lot of pace for old David James. Big, tall, couldn't hang on to it. Maybe a claim for a slight free kick, slight nudge in the back. The referee waved it on. Chorluka hits the side netting.
There's a hint there that Niko Kovac jumped into David James. The referee was well positioned. Saw nothing wrong. This is maybe a more instructive angle. Joe Cole. First scare for England from veteran Chorluka. England winning their share of free kicks.
Just looking for a good delivery. England, as you say, Frank Lampard took a corner, which is very weak. Free kick deflected. Just looking for that little bit of quality from England. So put it on Terry's head. Just bend it in towards the goal. Quality spot. You've got Heskey, Terry, and Ferdinand in there.
There's the general. Lampard. Rooney on. Nico Kovac's got a touch on that. And Fethi Kosha prevents a corner.
Oh, it's a poor delivery by Frank Lampard yet again. He's just got to really be confident on it. He just doesn't look as if he's got the belief. Put the ball in with a bit of pace.
Oh, Ashley Cole losing out. England backtracking. Olić so dangerous. Rakitic. Pranić. Rakitic. Beginning to look the part, the home side.
Well, it's a bold say, I'm sure. Slaven Bilic was a little bit worried for the first 5-10 minutes. England really did get after him, but it started to up the tempo, Croatia.
Cerna to Čorluka. Veteran Čorluka still. And John Terry has to go across.
Well, England at the moment have just lost the shape, they've lost the rhythm. They've just gone a little bit ragged. They've got to get concentration, get the shape back and start looking after the ball more. They're giving it away far too cheaply and they're not winning the second ball enough.
Causes for English concern. Cerna. There's Rooney's header away from the near post. Rio Ferdinand. Crowd getting on James's back, anticipating a bobble on the back pass.
Not tonight, I've got to say, the goal mouth is, especially the one David James is protecting at the minute, is very dug up in that 6-yard area.
Strong challenges. Olić stayed down for a while for Croatia. Gareth Barry. Now Lampard.
Just look now, John. When it goes to Frank Lampard and Gareth Barry, they're not positive enough to go, I'll get Ashley Cole in, or I will play to Wes Brown, or into the strike. I don't think the two midfield players yet have played up to Heskey or Wayne Rooney's feet yet. And it's a problem. They're playing little square balls. The Croatian defence are creeping up and it's very easy to stop.
Huskies flick on to no one in particular. Rooney's chased it anyway.
That's a classic case of Wayne Rooney coming too deep. You can see Wes Brown's looking at Heskey. He can only do one thing, John, flick it on. Wayne Rooney is playing deeper in the midfield.
It's not what Capello wants and not what England need. Barry. Simic. Kovac took a kick from Joe Cole.
I think it was a little bit late, Joe Cole, as Kovac played it. Joe Cole's playing very narrow.
very, very narrow. I know he wants him to get involved and play high up the field. I think Joe Cole, at times, is coming in too early inside. I think he's got his ball a little bit of width. Then when we get possession, obviously come inside and move.
Ashley Cole gave it away. Patrick's to Cerna. England are short at the back here. And Cerna's cross behind off John Terry.
And that's what Croatia are good at for me. They wait for a straight pass and they come and they break on you very, very quick as they did there. And I'm surprised Cerna didn't pick somebody out with the quality he's got in that right foot.
Rakitic. Robert Kovac. Cerna. First man for him to deal with is Rooney. Rooney stuck to his task.
All right, Cerna, very good player. Came on the scene as a right back and then sort of a wing back. But he's found his position on that right wing. Great delivery of the ball.
And Cerna turned after winning the corner and asked the crowd for more support, for more noise. And they've responded. Rooney's clearance. Modric. Simic. Luka. The Croatian side empowered and emboldened by their clever coach Slaven Bilic. They spent the last 3 days since their weekend win over Kazakhstan at their country retreat in Slovenia. Strange to prepare for a home game in a different country, but that's the way of it here. A place far away from the bright lights of Zagreb. No temptation for Bilic's players to go for a night on the town. And they're comfortable quarters they occupy, but hardly luxurious. A room in the Croatian team hotel is £40 a night.
I just look like Croatia. England did very well a couple of minutes ago. They pressed them, they made them play it long, and that's what you want to do in an ideal world. It's difficult, but I think England now are starting to tire. 21 minutes gone, and they really did put a lot of effort in that first 15-20.
Starting to tire after 21 minutes?
It's hot, it's very warm in the stadium, and I looked at England, yes, when they get the ball a little bit, but when they haven't got it, there's a few already looking for that second win. It's very difficult.
There's Brown. Rescues it for Frank Lampard. Walcott. Barry. Now Olic. Rooney. Looking for Walcott. Oh, and now was Heskey being manhandled there? He felt he was. Seems to be an arm around him from Josip Simunic, who was the man that gave away the penalty at Wembley. Talk about that more in a moment. Here's Rooney for England. Heskey. Again, Simunic at his shoulder, not quite as tight this time. And on by Petric for Olic. Good job that Wes Brown is covering.
Going back to the instance with Simunic, from where we're sitting, I thought that was a definite penalty for England. Yeah, it's a lovely feed by Walcott, great ball by Rooney to him. And you can see his arm is round his throat. Yes, whether he would have got the ball or not, it's not the point. He's brought him down. That is a clear penalty for England.
But fortune not with England. And if they are beginning to tire, that would have lifted flagging spirits. restore energy levels. Petric. Foul by Barrick.
He lost possession of the ball, Petric, but Gareth Bale did still block him off on his run. Come back, that penalty, that's what you need. You need that decision, you need the referee to be strong. We know the atmosphere has a bit hostile, but you need a good, strong referee there, because that was a clear penalty to England.
They don't come much more experienced than Lubos Mitchell. It's worth another look, I think, in fact.
Well, as you see, Walcott, terrific ball across the goal. For me, Heskey, whether he got or not, he wasn't allowed to get near it. Simonis was all over, and Capello, we can see reaction, and he's got a fair point. That was a clear penalty.
Heskey asked the question, expecting the answer yes, and was amazed to be told no by a referee who's officiated at two World Cups, two European Championships, and was also the man in the middle in the Champions League final between West Brom's Manchester United and Chelsea back in May. The Member of Parliament, Lubos Mitchell, back in his native Slovakia. James comes out to meet Olic.
You can see the game plan is, if you're getting good possession on the ball, see if he had a diagonal at the World Cup, but unfortunately tonight he hasn't had the impact as he did on the weekend. I know it was against Andorra, the part-timers, but nice ball across, which should have been a penalty, but apart from that he struggled to get into the game.
Ferdinand. Rooney. And it'll come for Walcott, and Joe Cole is free, and Walcott has scored for England! Celebrations from the posh seats, from the suits, and from the cheap seats and the supporters. Maybe a defining moment in a teenager's life, the day that a boy becomes a man.
Well, as I said, he's struggling to get in the game, his quality's been poor. But give him credit on this, hard and low. Got to say, the goalkeeper, Kletchkov, should have saved it, he should have got his hands to it, he should have pushed it away. But give him credit, he's been a thorn, without as much quality. But it was a right mess at the back for Croatia, and he had one thing on his mind. He did exactly right, he hit it across the goalkeeper. For me, the keeper should have saved it, but that's 1-0.
And that is 1-0 in Croatia. And the sort of goal that England have conceded against Croatia, they have now scored past the one born of defensive errors and poor goalkeeping. The outgoing chief executive and the man that decided he must leave United in this moment of joy, Theo Walcott, the surprise inclusion in the England team, is the man who has fired them in front for Fabio Capello. Here's Walcott again. And this time, it might have been going wide anyway, but Pletikosa got a touch and it's a corner.
Well, that was good play again by Walcott. You've got to give Capello a bit of credit here. He was brave enough to play the young boy. He's been very positive for two strikers. Walcott's played very hard in the field. That was another great effort there. Maybe could have picked Rooney out, but so far, so good for England.
So far, so very good. Lampard. Travelled a long way to get to Pletikosa, but at no height. But now Croatia try the counter. This is Cerna. Olic. Modric will pursue. Ashley Cole makes the challenge.
I think it's still dangerous, Croatia. We know they're home, but they're good on the break. And that's what England's got to be very wary of.
That's a foul. The Croatian free kick. Joe Cole lunging in. Capello from the touchline is preaching concentration. It's all right having the lead, it's about keeping it. Serna. Here comes James, who's blocked off, and Petric! It hit Wes Brown with the goalkeeper nowhere.
I think he's blocked off, David James. They're free kicks, and it's Kovacs who does it every time, and I'm very surprised the referee can't see that. It's very clear.
It's rather casual by Terry. Ashley Cole to Joe Cole. Ashley Cole was bundled over off the ball, and the referee's gone back for a free kick.
There's the goal. It's a good touch by Walcott. His first touch is excellent, and he does everything right. Hit it across the goalkeeper. If he saves it, there's Joe Cole to tap it in if he did save it.
What a time, what an occasion to bag a first international goal. And here is the goal scorer. Wes Brown. One for Walcott to chase. Three in the box for England, plus Frank Lampard. He hit Rooney. Lubos Mikšel plays an advantage. There was some shirt pulling by Lampard on Čorluka. Kranjic. Modric. Plenty to sing about and celebrate. England ahead in a country that has never experienced a home competitive defeat. Čorluka. Serna. Rakitic jumping with Brown. And reacting first. Corner kick.
England, just at times. England come off the pace of the game, John, and that's when they get the problems, don't they? When they play that high tempo and they're pressing the ball all over the park and playing at good speed, they're hard to live with.
Well, Croatia have loaded Simunic in there, and Čorluka, and Niko Kovac. But it matters not.
You take them all day. Surprised Sina never come across and took it. Takes some great deliveries.
Well, it's back to the Barclays Premier League, not for Slaven Bilic this weekend, although it might have been. But here on Setanta, Saturday tea time, Manchester City against Chelsea. Monday night, Tottenham versus Aston Villa, both live on this channel, as will be Spurs UEFA Cup tie against the Polish team Wisla Krakow, and that is a week tomorrow. By Barry. Simunic. Modric.
Well, the game plan's gone exactly how he's putting it out. You know, they're working hard in areas, picking a lot of setting balls up now. Controlling the pace of the game. When Croatia break, there's a lot of weight shirts playing the ball, but they're not back pedaling. They're actually going closing people down and nicking the ball off them and settling the rhythm.
Rooney is penalised. Stays down. dealing with Luka Modric tonight, and we'll have to deal with Luka Modric again on Monday night in one of those live games we were advertising, Tottenham against Aston Villa. Gary Lewin just waiting to see if he's required. They seem in a very good mood down there, Chris. Why wouldn't they be one up in Zagreb?
Well, they controlled it. I think a little spell of 5-10 minutes just before the goal, I thought they looked a bit tired, they got a bit strung out. Croatia started popping the ball around very well. Apart from that, they've controlled the game. Fantastic. Game plan so far has been excellent.
Wes Brown. Heskey making life awkward for Simunic, but by virtue of a foul on that occasion.
It's a good out-ball of Heskey, isn't he? Because he is mobile as well. He is good in the air, he's strong. All right, he doesn't probably score the amount of goals he should. But for an out-ball, when you're under pressure, he does fight really well and he gets a hold of it and links the play.
Ferdinand. Trying to play their way out from the back. Here's Rooney. Joe Cole.
They've done well. They've done well. I just think we can still, England can still pass the ball a lot better than what they have. But the one thing they're doing, they're not letting Croatia play. They're not letting Croatia, and Croatia don't like it, and they're pressing them very high up the field.
Heskey. Too much on it for Rooney that time. Cerna for Croatia. Sarjosa Asanovic, formerly of Derby, just behind Slaven Bilic, one of his assistants. And Ashley Cole was given a helping hand there by Dario Cerna.
Played out well, Ashley Cole. He knew exactly what he was doing. As soon as Cerna leant on him slightly, he was hitting the ground. And you know referees give free kicks very easily in these games, so he did everything right.
Give free kicks easily, this one doesn't give penalties easily, it seems.
Well, they're big decisions, isn't it? That's 10 yards outside the box, it's an easy one to give.
It's a foul on Lampard by Olic.
Confidence is definitely there. This is what you expect from England. You know, people say, can we play like Spain and Brazil? All these teams, we're good at playing high tempo, pressing teams.
In which case, my question to you, Chris, is after 5 moribund friendlies and a poor performance against a bunch of rank amateurs in Andorra, where has that confidence come from?
I think for the first time, England were actually underdogs tonight. All the games you've talked about have always been expected to win and win comfortably. All right, Czech Republic, they didn't play well. In certain games they haven't, but tonight they've come here and you could see a bit of determination about them and the right attitude. And Croatia are favourites, 5th in the world, on their home pitch.
Let's not forget though that England led in Russia. Crucial European Championship qualifier and ended up losing. So the lead at this stage, far from conclusive. Here's Niko Kovac. Prefer it on his right. He's looking for a free kick, which he's not going to get. And Theo Walcott emerges with it. and releases it just in time. This is Rooney. Heskey was lurking. Theo Walcott has been left on the ground by Josip Simunic, who's going to be yellow carded here. Robert Kovac, the captain, protesting, but Simunic, the man who, remember, has to be booked three times before he's dismissed from the field of play, gets the first yellow card of this particular night.
Well, it most definitely was a yellow card. It took Theo Walcott. That's what Walcott gives England. When England wanted a break there, they give it to Walcott. He covered the ground 30, 40 yards, and that was a clear foul. And he should have booked Kovacs as well on the edge of the box for diving. We can see that as a clear yellow card. Took him out, no attention to going for the ball.
They're unable to deal with Theo Walcott by fair means, so they've indulged in foul means, and it's not looking particularly good for the teenager. Several members of the England staff, Mark Sartori, one of the masseurs out there, Fabio Capello, clearly very concerned about his young starlet. He's decidedly groggy.
You don't need Walcott to come off at the moment. He's a great outlet forward. His pace alone has caused so many problems. Obviously he scored the goal, but his pace alone has caused so many problems to Croatia.
And you saw there the four outfield players not stripped for tonight's game, including David Bentley, who seems to have been overtaken on this particular international trip by Theo Walcott. Walcott, who's been driven onto the running track on the back of a golf buggy. And it's looking rather brighter for him now. One or two smelling salts might be in order. England at the moment still playing with 10, but Walcott just coming back on now. Olic for Serna. Dario Serna letting fly. Back to the same player who was pushed. Silly free kick to give away.
Spot on, John. Silly position. You know Croatia technically are excellent around this area, this range. And it was Wayne Rooney tracking back again. Maybe coming a little bit too deep. And he did give away a free kick on Serna.
Well, the good news for England is that Nico Kranjčar is injured. The bad news is that Dario Serna is every bit as good. Ivan Rakitic could also have a go, and so too Nico Kovac, but the stage has been cleared for Dario Serna here.
Amazing, Serna, he go over the wall to David James, left side, is good enough to get this ball up and over.
For once, it's Croatia needing some form of restoration and rescue. It's Serna, and the wall still its ground. Čurluka. Walcott. Serna. Back to Čurluka. Robert Kovac. Theo Walcott is seeing stars in front of his eyes, and a bit of double vision or something. He chose the right football to head when it came his way there. There's Kranjic. Rakitic. Olic. And things are happening tonight to Croatia that have been happening to England.
Well, you've got to give England credit. The pressures on Croatia, England have really matched them physically. They've picked the ball up. As I say, you can always say with England, they can pass the ball better. We say that every game. But so far, the game plan, what Capello sent out, is working a treat. That's another foul. Simic has got to watch himself. He's already on a yellow. He's just took Heskey down.
Simic is the Croatian defender with whom Graham Paul had his unfortunate moment in the World Cup. He's also a defender who's been sent off six times in the last 2 years. Ashley Cole. Heskey. No one there for England.
Great tracking back by Rooney. That's what he's good at, we know. Sometimes he goes too deep, and we do talk about it. We'd rather have him up higher up the field for England. just coming off Heskey 10, 15 yards, not too deep.
Cerna. Great kick.
England are moving reasonably serenely towards half-time here in the Maximir Stadium. Propelled into that comfortable position by Theo Walcott's 26th-minute goal, his first for his country. And England might also have had a penalty. Denied them when Simunic seemed to pull back Emil Heskey, but Lubos Mitchell didn't agree. So far, it seems that those observers who suggested that Fabio Capello often starts his managerial reign at a new post with some relatively unimpressive displays, but then when it matters, he and his players produce, well, it may be happening again. Which is not to say there won't be some very awkward moments in the second half. Modric for Rakitic. England still have some defending to do in this first half.
I don't really think it was a horse free kick. Walcott chasing back. Rakitic going down very easy. He's just basically trying to wrestle inside him. He knew what he's doing, Rakitic. I'm sure we'll see Cerna again.
Although Rakitic is taking more of an interest in this one. In fact, he's dismissed Cerna from the scene. So 20-year-old Ivan Rakitic of Schalke. Born in Switzerland to Croatian parents. And a star in the making. Rakitic always rising.
David James will be pleased. He'll have to take them all day. But you've got to say, in his game plan, John's work brilliant first half. They've worked hard. I don't know if they can sustain the tempo of what they've done over the course of 90 minutes. But first half so far, game plan's been spot on. Great goal by Walcott. But they've hustled, they've unsettled Croatia, and they don't like it.
Niko Kovac. And England would happily take the half-time whistle now, which is precisely what they've got from Lubos Mitchell. And the players in white turn and head towards the antiquated tunnel end of this Maximir Stadium. And it's Slaven Bilic with the problems and the head scratching, and England with the lead. Given them by the youngest player on the pitch, Theo Walcott, midway through a first half that England have largely controlled. They will feel they should have had a penalty as well, but hey, be grateful for what they do have, which is a well-taken goal by Walcott and a half-time lead in Zagreb. It's Croatia 0, England 1.
He is still only 19, but he has given England an impressive lead here in Zagreb, and that doesn't happen often. Verdicts from Macca, Sam and Terry are next. Sunday morning, a boxing date for your diary. Campbell against Guzman, the WBC, WBO lightweight title. Sunday morning, 3 o'clock on Setanta Sports 1. Here in Zagreb, England lead at half-time by a goal to nil. Terry, not a scoreline we were expecting.
Well, we were hoping for it, but we're only halfway there. But I must say, I think we've organised ourselves really, really well. And we've not been frightened to go up there and close them down. That's what shocks them. And that's what normally they do. They do that to you. And we've just played them at their own game. And from it, they've not been out. I don't think they've passed more than three or four passes going forward the whole half.
They've stopped Croatia from playing.
Yeah, we've been very positive right from the outset, haven't we? And we look very comfortable now. We're knocking the ball around. The chance that we have, the penalty decision, we'll see. We're knocking the ball around, playing with a lot of confidence, and got the goal. And as Sam mentioned before the game, mistakes will win and lose the game for us. And I think if we continue to be solid, which we look at the moment, we'll go on and win this game.
Sam, and it was a mistake that led to the goal, but credit to Rio Ferdinand as well for his role in it.
Yes, I think this is what surprised the Croatians. Even Rio was coming out the back and trying to play here and carrying on his movement, and we get a little bit of luck with a deflection, but it's really very, very poor defending just there. Hits his own player, but give all credit to Theo Walcott. That's a magnificent finish. Bottom corner, narrow angle. He had one similar to that a few minutes before that and completely misses it, trying to pull it back. And it's going to give him a huge amount of confidence. And of course, we hope we continue this pressing of the Croatia side and force them into more mistakes.
Poor mistake by Kranjic knocking it against Kovac. You know, this is big, big decisions, this, and you know, unfortunately for us, we're on the right side of it today.
This is Fabio Capello's reaction to the goal. Just wait for it. Ah, there you go.
Yeah.
With the composure that Theo Walcott has shown there, Terry,
I think he's given Kranjic a big problem, and he showed it in that situation where Steve's talking about. The move had actually broken down for us. He got to it with time, and instead of being cool, he just slashed at it, and no matter how hard you hit it, if it hits someone, it comes back here. And a great finish, terrific finish from Walcott.
Was it a penalty for you?
I think we were all in agreement that it was a foul, but we can also see why it wasn't given. The referee was the wrong side, but this is great movement from us. You see, keeping the ball well. Rooney, a wonderful pass to the far post to Theo Walcott. And you can see Simunic has got his arm round Heskey, but you can also see that there wasn't much of an appeal by our lads.
Sam, as a manager, would you have been disappointed with a decision like that?
Yes, but I mean, at the end of the day, you can see where the referee is, and Emil's on the opposite side to the referee and perhaps can't see from that angle, so he doesn't see the arm going round Emil, so
he's more animated
about that than he is about the goal, but I'm sure he was delighted inside.
OK, we're going to take a break. England have never lost to the same side three times in a row. They could be on their way to protecting that record. They lead by a goal to nil at halftime here in Zagreb. The second half is next. Domestic action on Saturday from the City of Manchester Stadium. It's Manchester City against Chelsea from 4 o'clock on one. Then on Monday night, it's Tottenham against Aston Villa. And then on Thursday, Tottenham are in European action. Let's go back to John and Chris.
Lucas Michel poised. No changes to either side. And the second half now about to get underway. It is the 50th game that Croatia have played in this Maksimir Stadium, and they have lost just two. Both of those were friendlies back in the mists of time. So that perhaps puts into context how big an achievement it would be for England to hang on to this lead, or indeed add to it, in the next 45 minutes. And England are first to win a free kick.
Well, as far as I'll be able, do exactly the same, keep working, keep pressing them, don't let them settle on the ball, don't let them pass the ball around easy. Right areas, go and press them, and when we get, be alive, everybody look for England, little wait here, everybody try and get the ball and play quickly.
And the dangers for England?
Tiredness. I think to play at a high tempo over this 90 minutes is very, very difficult. I think after an hour you'll see a lot of players in a white shirt start tiring.
Lampard is aimed towards Heskey, who was levered off the ball, but he is deemed to have committed the foul. There's more good news for one of our home nations as we watch a reprise of Lampard's free kick, which was no great threat. Second Scotland goal in Reykjavik. Barry Robson has scored. Iceland 0, Scotland 2. Which is just what they need after their defeat at the weekend. Up goes Heskey. Gareth Barry. Ashley Cole was caught by Cerner, who's going to be yellow carded for that.
Well, he turned very well, Ashley Cole, and Cerner did catch him on the ankle. Whether it was a yellow card, I'm not too sure.
Did seem to rake a few studs down the back of the calf. Mario Cerner, who's a fairly demonstrative player. Some of the VIPs looking skywards in the hope of divine intervention. President Stepien Mesic and the Prime Minister Ivo Sanader both carded to be here this evening. tackled by Terry. Musky thought about chasing. Walcott has chased it all the way and only loses by about a yard.
Just misjudged that one, did he? Could have saved his legs a bit, but that's a great out ball. Heskey's very mobile as well. It'd be interesting to see what Billich said at half-time, because he cannot be happy the way they perform, and he's probably surprised how England really got in the faces high up the park and didn't let them pass it. Has he got a plan B?
I'm sure we'll see Slaven Billich in a moment. In fact, there he is at the bottom of your screen, briefly. He's dispensed with his jacket. Looks like he means business. Matches are difficult for him because it's the only time he's not allowed to smoke. He's a chain smoker. That's the reason for the free kick. Rakitic. Olic. Almost Brown will allow that to run through to David James.
That's good as well, John England. Oh, it's a terrible throw by David James.
And here's Luka Modric. England have regrouped in the middle. Rakitic, Petric, Niko Kovac. And the Croatian supporters frustrated. Rooney to Heskey. Nicely for Rooney, and Rooney runs into a statue called Simunic, who's treading a fine line because he was booked in the first half.
Well, Wayne Rooney doesn't. You know, he's in. Wayne Rooney's in for a shot there. That is a clear yellow card, so really he should have two and he should have been gone. That is a clear foul.
Well, the considerable England coaching staff in terms of both reputation and number watching on as Frank Lampard and Gareth Barry stand over this. Billich cutting a rather hangdog figure right now. It's Lampard! Spilt by the goalkeeper, and Robert Kovac is first to react.
Good strike by Frank Lampard, hard and low. It was a decent save. The man who was following was Rio Ferdinand.
Lampard again. Terry. Walcott waiting for the ball to come, but he was fouled and the free kick was taken from the wrong place, but on we go. And Heskey almost profiting as Kleti Kosha spilt it. Goal kick in the end.
Well, this is a good test for Croatia, isn't it? Crowd's getting very restless, they're moaning at the players giving the ball away. And England have just really dominated the possession. No contact between the goalkeeper and the centre-half, Kovacs. That could have proved costly as well.
England's goal stemmed from Daniel Pranić whacking an attempted clearance into the back of Robert Kovac. Bounced kindly for Theo Walcott. Barry. Luka Modric for Croatia. It's not yet been the influence that the home side hoped. Rooney. Oh, that was a clattering that Joe Cole took from Robert Kovac. A real clattering. And he led with the arm as well.
Joe Cole, as he got back to his feet, you'll see here, it's a terrific header, the arm's going to cross him. But as he got up, Joe Cole, he walked about 3 yards and then collapsed.
That's the reason for the concern. So he did take a couple of paces. So we look again at Frank Lampard's free kick that was partially stopped. And the referee has issued a card to Robert Kovac.
I don't know, they're just obviously they're disputing the decision. I saw blood trickling down the side of Joe Cole's head. But obviously they're not happy with the decision. He did catch him with his elbow.
He led with the arm, and it's a red card, I'm sure, from the referee Lubos Mitchell. He brandished a card to the sky so quickly and put it straight back in his pocket, but I'm sure it was red for this.
It is. He's gone to the dugout. Kovacs. Robert Kovac. He's gone. Red card. Not happy. And he can't sit in the dugout neither.
A sending off offence for the captain. There we are. Confirmation of the straight red for Robert Kovac for leading with his arm and catching Joe Cole. And Fabio Capello, whilst obviously pleased to see Croatia a man down, is still worried about Joe Cole's state of fitness. The worrying fact being that he took a couple of paces before collapsing. And the England medical staff out there in some numbers.
Oh, just hope Joe Cole's okay. I think he's going to leave the field, obviously, what he's done on that stretch. I don't know if he'll be coming back. Will he put Downing on? How's he going to balance his side?
Well, major problems now for Bilic. England looking to have to replace Joe Cole. Jermaine Genus is amongst those being made ready. He would be one of the obvious replacements, and Stuart Pearce giving him one or two instructions out there. Instructions now from the top man. But Kovac seemed clearly to lead with his arm. Are you convinced it was intentional?
I think it was a little bit there, definitely. I think it was a terrific header. First of all, when you looked at it, you thought, what a powerful header. But his arm's very high. Unfortunately, by Joe Cole, he's took a severe blow to the head. We just thought he was okay. Janus, I think, would, if he plays him left, be interesting. Could easily put Gareth Barry left side and put Janus centre midfield, which he plays for Spurs.
Well, there did seem to be malice. And it was certainly a sickening collision that has left Joe Cole with blood pouring from a wound to the right side of his head. And he has to be replaced by Jermaine Genus. But Lubos Mitchell, the man in red, has brandished red at Robert Kovac, and Croatia are a goal down and a man down now. Is Pranic.
You just hope the referee is strong. It's very easy to, and any silly challenge by an England player could easily result in a red itself. And any decision in a box, you need a strong referee now.
Well, there's also a substitution being made by Croatia now. As a result of the sending off, they're having to rearrange. And so Mladen Petric comes off, one of the strikers, and Dario Knezovic, who's a central defender, will go in alongside Simunic. Croatia in the position where they've lost one man to a red card and could well have had his centre-back partner Simunic sent off as well.
England's just got to stay focused, keep passing the ball, use the ball well. They've obviously got an extra man, but keep this tempo. That's been the secret of England's success, working Croatia very hard.
Luka with this for Croatia. Back from Knezovic. Simunic. Lampard winning it cleanly. And there is Joe Cole on his way to further more detailed medical attention in the dressing room. Niko Kovac for Croatia. It's not the first time he's done that. He could well have been booked in the first half for diving. And the referee, Lubos Mitchell, again unimpressed. Genus giving away a free kick.
Bad referee. That's twice he's done it, John. That's a yellow card on both occasions.
Olic. There's a latest challenge by Terry. It's becoming fractious.
England's just got to keep focus on the game. Don't get involved. Just keep doing the things they've been doing.
Knezovic. Charged down by Rooney. Choluka. Breaks for Barry. Wes Brown. Heskey. Rooney. Ashley Cole making the extra man on his outside. Lampard. Heskey. And Rooney opts to pass. Theo Walcott. What a night for the teenager. And what a night it's turning into for Fabio Capello in England.
What a night, what a goal. Fantastic football. Heskey to Rooney on the left-hand side. Wayne Rooney played a lovely little give and go. Ends up back to Heskey, back to Rooney. He rolls it to Walcott. Very similar finish to the goal in the first half. Didn't he take it ever so well? Rooney, terrific play. First touch was good, second touch was excellent. Across the keeper again, bottom corner. Fantastic goal by England.
It was Choluka that played him onside. Didn't step up. And a goal not dissimilar to his first. Low, accurate, into the bottom corner, across the goalkeeper. This time no hand from Pletikosa. And 2-0 up against 10 men. Are England going to be the first side to win a competitive international in Croatia?
That was a wonderful goal, John. The football was excellent. Lovely play. And the thing, you've got to give them credit. We're very easy people knock England. But tonight, you've got to say, they've had a fantastic game plan. Give the manager credit. And they've worked ever so hard for each other.
Well, might they sing and dance. Heskey, not the best of challenges on Niko Kovac, who has made an awful lot of it. It's a yellow card for Emil Heskey.
Just got to watch himself, Heskey, no need. I thought he played the ball. Obviously the referee thought different, and Kovac does go down very, very easily. For me, that is a decent challenge. The ball's come out the side of Heskey's foot. Kovac making a meal of it yet again.
Terry, more height than distance, and Terry goes down clutching his face, quickly up again, and clashed with Rakitic. Rooney, first touch not as adhesive as he might have liked. Now is a time for calm English heads amidst the maelstrom of the Maximir. Wayne Rooney. Heskey waiting all on his own. It's going to come for Gareth Barry.
Worth a chance, England now totally in control. The heads of Croatia have dropped. And you can see now they're going to make another substitution.
Yes, and they're taking off Niko Kovac. So the younger brother was sent off. The older brother and skipper, as we watch Theo Walcott's rapier-like finish for England's second. The skipper is taken off. Wonderful moment for Theo Walcott and for English football. It's Pokrovac who's come on in place of Niko Kovac. And we can bring in Dan Rowan for news of poor Joe Cole.
Well, I can tell you, John, that Joe appears to have a quite severe gash to his forehead. There's blood pouring from a wound on his head. And what will concern the medical team of England, of course, is the fact, John, that he did appear to stagger a few steps before collapsing, which does suggest a degree of concussion. But let's hope he's heard all about England's second goal. That may well have improved his mood.
Thank you, Dan. Dan Rowan, our pitchside reporter here in Zagreb tonight. And England sitting pretty. Genus to Ashley Cole. And Genus will keep it in. And Croatia stopped for a moment there. And here's Wayne Rooney to make it three! just gets better for England. On a night that promised so little, they have delivered so much.
Full credit, Ashley Cole, great persistence down this left-hand side, and Turner, Janus picks it up, and he does ever so well, drives to the byline, outside the right-foot pullback, Wayne Rooney from the penalty spot, a lovely opening, right-foot up, side-foot, past the goalkeeper, didn't need to blast it, just placed it, rolled it past the keeper, and England have deserved it, they've been outstanding.
Wayne Rooney, whose finest display with the three lions on his chest came against Croatia in that game at Euro 2004 in Lisbon's Stadium of Light. He's barely scored a competitive goal since then, but he scored what we must consider now surely to be the clincher here. 2-0 against a side numerically reduced, always likely to be a winning lead. 3-0, certain to be. And for only the third time, Slaven Bilic is about to experience defeat as a manager. Rooney, Lampard to Barry. Rooney once more. Walcott. And Petr Koša having to hurry. I'll bring you up to date with another goal in Reykjavik. As we look at the possession stats for the last 5 minutes, which are striking. But Iceland have pulled one back against Scotland in Reykjavik. A Gudjonsson penalty. Iceland 1, Scotland 2. That game live over on Setanta Sports 2 at the moment. Genus. To expect a challenge that didn't come. Eske. John Terry. Walcott. Barry. Here's Genus.
Some of the football now, the confidence is unbelievable. Players are really enjoying the ball. Yes, they've got an extra man. But before that, England, for me, dominated the game. Croatia really haven't asked any questions, even when they had 11 men.
Well, maybe Fabio Capello was just kidding Croatia for the last 8 months, encouraging his team to put in performances that were not at their highest level, shall we say, in games that really didn't matter. Whatever the whys and the wherefores, they have produced when it really does matter. Barry. Ashley Cole. Is Heskey. Just behind for a goal kick. And not all the Croatian supporters are actually still in the stadium. Some have left. There's a sound of upturned plastic bucket seats as Rooney struck England's third. Croatia's record at home in competitive games prior to tonight, played 35, won 25, drawn 10.
If you look at England tonight, yes, this save was well quite, he was brave to go with him, whatever people say. Capello's picked his side up for a reason, but it's been a team effort. Well, Cole get a little headlines, there's no doubt about that. But as a team, they've done everything right.
Here's Rooney, as England look for more. Wasn't the best of passes, though. And it's Chorluka.
I think that's a success, how England's going to get success or qualify for tournaments and do well in tournaments. It's about the team, the work effort, the organisation. We haven't got sparkling individuals, which certain countries have got, but as a group, and if they play like this, at the speed, this tempo, they're a hard side to beat.
Well, there's a couple split down the middle on a night like tonight. Formula One Supremo Bernie Eccleston and his wife Slavica, who's Croatian. No foul on Rooney there. So on we go with Cerna. Unlike those England supporters, looking a dispirited bunch. Some movement down on the bench, and David Beckham is at the centre of it in the England dugout. Here's Rooney. Super ball for Walcott. Brown. Rakitic, Cerna, Pokrovac, Pokrovac, Olic. There's Brown tidying up.
I don't think Eski was rubbing his knee a lot there. I don't know if he's sort of slight knocker, he's felt some twinge, but he didn't look comfortable.
Well, Croatia about to make another substitution. To see a striker, Mario Mandzukic. England content to keep the ball and protect their lead, their hugely impressive lead. Two goals for Walcott, one for Wayne Rooney. And Croatia playing this second half with 10 men after Robert Kovac was sent off. Walcott, Lampard, Rooney.
Keep doing it, keep keeping the ball, let them run. The game's over, let them chase. They'll be quite happy, actually. Croatia, damage limitation for them now.
Genus. Rio Ferdinand. Off scampers Ashley Cole.
Lovely football. Lovely football. A great run by Ashley Cole. Unfortunately, the cross was too high. Just need a little bit of composure to square across to a white shirt.
Well, it's Olic who's making way. It's not had his usual impact for Croatia. Sullen face and a scowl tells its own story. And Mario Mandzukic, another of the bright young things of Croatian club football, comes on for only his second cap. No noise, no animation from supporters who are renowned for both.
Mario Mandzukic.
wonder if Slaven Bilic is wondering whether he made a mistake in not being more receptive to the overtures of West Ham United.
He would never predict this result tonight. I don't think anybody has.
Ashley Cole. As Heskey is offside. Referee, though, has... Yes, he's given the free kick for the offside. Which is probably something of a relief to Dario Knežević.
Wasn't a lot in it. I guess he made a little bit of a meal of it, but he drifted off from an offside position.
Genus through the middle. Simunic. Cerna. Well, it's a stunning scoreline. And there are echoes of, what, 7 years ago now in Munich. When 2.5 weeks after losing a home friendly against the Netherlands, in very tame fashion, Sven-Göran Eriksson, still new in his post, took England to Munich and inflicted a first ever home competitive defeat on Germany. This, certainly in terms of margin, similarly unexpected and similarly laudable. Ashley Cole to Rooney. Jermaine Genus. Lampard. Back from Ashley Cole. Frank Lampard for four. No. A free kick has been given. It's beautifully taken by Lampard, but Croatia escaped the ignominy of conceding a fourth goal on home soil.
That was just fantastic football again. The way they're spraying the ball around, the movement. They're all confident now, they're all enjoying it. And it was just a shame there was a slight infringement which cost Frank Lampard what would have been a marvellous goal.
Could have been as good as any of England's goals.
Well, we can't see what's happening. He's done ever so well. Lovely little 1-2 with Cole. And it was Heskey. Did he really push Simunic down? The referee judged he had. And unfortunately for Frank Lampard, to be chalked off.
Not to say a fourth won't come.
Wonderful goal. Well, there was nothing really in it. Referee's got a good view though, the angle he's at, but what a performance by him.
Something to put the smile back on the face of England's many supporters, whose patience has been tested so often.
Confidence has grown, John, with the way they're playing now. You can see that they're all enjoying it. Croatia really threw the towel in, let's be honest. And England can do what they want with the football at the moment. But they've got to look back. And, you know, if I make Capello should show the first half to them when they get back up again, say, this is why we did it, because of the work rate, the organisation, and how we press the teams. And if you don't let teams play like England do, and the way, obviously, they dominated the game, England wants to score, they've been the better side. That's because they've never let Croatia play. They've got to take that on board. That's the strength, the big strength of our England play.
Better news of Joe Cole from the England dressing room. He doesn't need to go to hospital. Nasty blow to the head. The foul by Robert Kovacs that led to the Croatian defender being sent off. He's got a nasty cut. He doesn't require hospital treatment. Walcott. All around us in the main stand, vast open grandstand here at the Maximir. There's a crush by the exits. People try and leave, but here comes Cerna, trying to restore a little bit of pride. Maybe now Mandzukic bets his first international goal, and Croatia at least are on the score sheet.
Well, was there a possibility of a free kick with a high foot by Cerner or John Terry? The referee hesitated, thought he was going to blow, he didn't. Give Cerner credit, he kept running. Lovely way to pass. The substitute, Mandzukic, come on. First real touch, and it's a wonderful finish. Just places it by. Lovely way to ball by Cerner. Good first touch, just under the body of David James. Sloppy play by England.
You can see John Terry clutching his head in the background. And he's still contending to the referee that Cerner's foot was too high and it should have been a free kick. But play allowed to continue. Mandzukic marks his second cap with a goal, but that was high.
That's a free kick. That is a free, that's high foot. John Terry hasn't bowed down to head it. It's, you know, Cerner's right foot's gone as high as John Terry and it should have been a free kick.
Well, you can see the point that John Terry is making. But the foot was outrageously high. It should have been an England free kick. Instead, it became a Croatian goal.
Capello really having a go at the referee. You can see he's not happy. He's got a good point. It's a good finish. Lovely weight of ball by Cerner. Paid at his team. Drew Real Ferdinand. Lovely touch by the substitute. Great finish.
So within a matter of a couple of minutes, Frank Lampard thought he'd scored at one end. Croatia have scored at the other, but really, they shouldn't have had the opportunity. Having been allowed to continue, it was well taken. Walcott. Rooney. Brown, Heskey.
Decent ball in by Wes Brown. I think England really just got to keep the ball. What they were doing, don't leave themselves bare at the back. They don't need to. Shut the back door, just keep possession, run the clock down. Game over.
Barry. Genus. Foul given against Chorluka.
Yeah, definite foul, Chorluka. Bringing down his teammate at Tottenham. Jermaine Genus. You can see he's dived in. Genus just moves the ball off. Definite free kick.
And England with a chance to restore their three-goal cushion.
I'd like to see Frank Lampard shoot here. There's a massive gap at that near post. If he hits it with a lot of pace.
Well, Rio Ferdinand is a late arrival. Heskey's in there. Lampard does go for the near post, but not with any great threat. And the hard taskmaster is up from his seat, still demanding more. Rooney, lovely ball, it's Walcott, it couldn't be, could it? It is, you know, it's a hat-trick for Theo Walcott. Just sensational. And the referee has had to go and sort out an argument amongst a group of Croatian and English players in the centre circle. But the goal stands. Theo Walcott has scored a hat-trick as a teenager for England, his first international goals, and England are in the process of recording one of their most stunning victories for many a long year.
Well, what you didn't see and what we're not talking about, John, is Wayne Rooney's fantastic control to bring that ball down. Here it is, what a touch to move it inside. The weighted pass, the perfect run by Walcott. Maybe we thought he was going to have a touch too many, kept his head. Didn't blast it, placed it into the net. Wayne Rooney's contribution was absolutely first class. What a night for Theo Walcott. Three goals.
The night he emerged from the shell which has in part protected him in his formative years, given a central leading role, and how he's responded. And here's Heskey, and Rooney is seeking an England fifth. Heskey then fouling Simunic from behind.
playing really second half has just been different class. Second half, first half I thought he did some nice things, contributed to the first goal, but overall he didn't really get in the game. But second half, he's just ran the game for England.
Well, he is the first England player to score a hat-trick since Peter Crouch against Jamaica at Old Trafford more than 2 years ago. And just as Michael Owen bagged a competitive hat-trick, as Mandzukic goes through and collides with David James, there was no foul, and Mandzukic is lacking support, and Serna will go for goal off target. And David James is down injured for England, but just as Michael Owen bagged that hat-trick, the last competitive triumvirate of goals for England in Munich, so Theo Walcott has done the same tonight.
Well, Theo Walcott, absolutely. He's probably pinching himself. He can't believe it. Going back to that there, James and Terry, bit of confusion. You don't need that. Could have proved costly. David James got a little bit of treatment. So, a right idea. Try to love James. Scurrying back his goal. Beckham's coming on for Walcott, who I'm sure is going to get massive applause from the England following to our right.
A night on which Theo Walcott will always look back, because it's the night and the occasion and the match when he's responded to the entreaties of a manager who at last has trusted him, and he has emerged onto the world stage in a way that we all knew was possible one day, but that day has come much, much sooner than we thought. Beckham on for his 105th cap, and what a nice cameo to have.
Well, it's great with David Beckham to get that cap, but headlines is all going to be Walcott. It's strange, I've watched him play a lot for Arsenal. Never really gets in the game, never really goes past people. But what he's got, and what's obviously been great for England, we've been crying out a bit of pace on the flanks. But what he's done well is when he's got in the positions, he's used the ball well or he's finished well. And it's already having a lot of pace, but the point is if you can't use it. And tonight, he's put his game together.
And England, who would have been delighted to leave here with a draw, are on the point of departing Croatia on their flight back to Luton this evening with a very handsome win. And don't forget that Theo Walcott, until 2 hours before kickoff, wasn't even sure he was going to play. Here's Beckham. And Croatia's remaining supporters try and rouse themselves into a meaningful chorus. But this is one huge step along the potentially tricky road to South Africa for England. Only the second of 10 qualification games. Group winners go through. Group runners-up in all probability going to a playoff. But this puts England in position A in Group 6. It's a year before they meet Croatia again, and that'll be at Wembley. We may see Matthew Upson fairly shortly, probably in place of John Terry.
Big statement this, not just in our group, in England's group, sorry, around Europe, everywhere. People will be looking at this and thinking, what a result. Whether they had 10 men or not, I still think England would have went on and won the game well.
Well, England were already ahead when Robert Kovacs was sent off 7 minutes into this second half. Walcott with three, Rooney with the other. England might well have had a first-half penalty. They've had a goal ruled out for a foul that was far from clear by Emil Heskey, denying Frank Lampard a goal. And here's Genus. Most impressive show of solidarity from the Croatian fans, taking a beating like this, and yet all standing and clapping rhythmically. Ashley Cole. England have been the ones that have been impressive on the pitch tonight. Here comes Upson, the third and final change for England. Luka Modric will return to Spurs. John Terry has a big game for Chelsea at Manchester City on Saturday, which you can see live here on Setanta. John Terry has led the team well, passes on the armband to Rio Ferdinand. And Matthew Upson of West Ham gets to enjoy the last two or three minutes.
Slight precaution, good time to come in, 4-1 up, 88 minutes.
And Upson immediately involved in winning a throw for England. So where would you place this in terms of recent England performances and indeed results?
I think when it was 11 against 11, Joe, I thought the game plan was excellent. You know, as I said, they closed Croatia down, didn't let them play higher up the field. And when we got, when England got it, they used it quite well. I still think they could have used it better. But when they went 1-0, I thought it was a relief. Then the confidence started growing. 2, obviously the red card, then it's been all England. But you really should be looking at the first half and how they prepared and what they did. Most teams, when you play a teammate Croatia, drop one time on the ball. And I think that's what England's secret has been tonight. It's been a team effort. I've got to say, World Cup got the headlines, but Wayne Rooney's been unbelievable, especially second half.
And the scoreline is barely believable. Here's Rooney. We're expecting 3 extra minutes at the end of this one. Genus. Will have 6 points from their opening two fixtures. When those fixtures were decided in Zagreb back in January, Fabio Capello was less than happy with beating the Croatians so early in the campaign in their fortress of a stadium. But all's well that ends well. And Luka was caught there by Rooney. Well, that's a good sight. Joe Cole back, compos mentis, nasty wound, but no lasting damage. The victim of Robert Kovac's elbow. A few stitches in there.
Well worth it, you say, after with a great result like that.
Luka and company, those that play in the Barclays Premier League, hope to return to their clubs in triumph. But they're on the end of the sort of beating that Croatia just haven't experienced before. Serna. Pesky's header out as far as Modric. And 4-1, of course, does wonders for England's goal difference in what may still turn out to be a tight group. And just as importantly, damages Croatia's. The likelihood is that Croatia will put a few more goals past Andorra than England did.
Long way to go, John, but end of the day, England's been asked to win 2 games. Everybody thought they wouldn't get a point here even. So you've got to give them credit. Give Capello some credit. He's got his game plan right.
Serna. And that's been given as a goal kick. And England don't have much more to do. There's the star of the show. A burgeoning talent who's exploded into the much wider consciousness in the space of the last 90 minutes. If there are football fans in various corners of the world that hadn't heard of Theo Walcott before, they certainly have now. Serna. Ashley Cole comes back for more and commits a foul.
It's been a good battle tonight, Serna and Ashley Cole. Very good battle. I don't think as much. It is a foul, but Turner's been looking for it.
England just seconds away from a stellar result as Lubos Mitchell looks at one watch, then another, and confirms that England have become the first team ever to win a competitive international in Croatia. They have stormed the citadel, the first part of the revenge mission, successfully, nay, spectacularly accomplished, leaving Croatia as depressed and distraught as England supporters have been so often in the recent past. Theo Walcott, the youngest player out there, the hero, with his first international goals and a hat-trick to boot. Wayne Rooney, who pulled the strings so successfully, was an integral part of things for England as well. Chris Waddle, your final thoughts as the players leave this Maximir pitch victorious?
I'll get a DVD and I'd make sure the team watched it, especially the first half. Look at the organisation and the effort, the work rate they put in. And then once they've won the battle, some of the football was excellent to watch, even though it went to 10 men. Got to say, England at times, Walcott will get the headlines. Wayne Rooney, for me, second half outstanding. And that is really the benchmark now they've set. When they're organised and they work hard, England's a difficult team to play against. It's about the team now rather than individuals.
A giant step on the road to South Africa, 2010. I wonder, did you ever really doubt Fabio Capello? Thought not. What a scoreline. And what a night for England. Echoes of Munich. And Fabio Capello has got England up and running in the best possible style. Croatia 1, England 4 is a scoreline to savour.
Yes, a night you and England and Theo Walcott will never, ever forget. The night the boy became a man. A tearaway teenager who simply terrified Croatia, who not just ripped up the record books, he and England destroyed them to a pulp, scintillating special England. The reaction you want to hear is right next. More live football coming your way tomorrow night from the Blue Square Premier. That's Lewis against Russian and Diamonds from 7:30 here on One. On Saturday, we're in Scotland at Fir Park, Motherwell against Celtic from 11:30. Plenty of European football for you as well from the various leagues across Europe, from the Bundesliga. Eintracht Frankfurt against Karlsruhe, that's Friday at 7 here on 1. We go to France on Saturday, Bordeaux against Marseille, that's over on 2, and then back on 1. In the Dutch leagues, it's Roda against Ajax from 1:25 on Sunday afternoon. Well, revenge is a dish best served cold. Well, England have waited for the right time, and boy, have they paid Croatia back. 4-1, it finished. Thank you very much, Theo Walcott. Let's hear from Theo now. He's with Dan.
Theo, many congratulations. Incredible night for England, an incredible night for you. Describe what it was like to be the star of such a performance.
Well, I said there was 11 stars and a whole team stars out there today. We just showed to everyone, the fans, everyone involved with England, how strong we are as a unit. Just proved it tonight. It was absolutely brilliant.
Talk us through each of your three goals, because they'll live with you forever.
Yeah, well, the first two are very similar. I tend to cross them quite a lot, so I just thought I'd be a bit more greedy this time. And then the third one, left foot, just a brilliant ball by Waza. He's just been absolutely brilliant, like everyone else was today.
Describe what it means to you. You've worked a long time to get to this position. You were handed your chance by Fabio Capello, and how determined were you to take it?
Well, you always got to take, when you play for England, you got to put 100% in, like everyone does. And I'm just grateful that he's given me an opportunity, and I just got to take that forward now to each and every game and just keep on improving.
Croatia have never lost a competitive match, Theo, here at the Maximir. Tonight they were beaten 4-1. What on earth happened? How did you produce this performance as a team?
Well, it just shows how together we are since this whole camp. It's been a long 10 days, but we showed, you know, how strong we are as a whole unit. The football we were playing is absolutely brilliant, and the goals we just scored, you know, we could do that against anyone.
You can hear the fans cheering your name, cheering the manager's name. They seem happy again. You put a smile back on their faces. What does that mean to you to have done that?
It's brilliant. You always want to see, you know, fans happy. You know, they're brilliant tonight. They always spur us on. But we just want to just prove to everyone, you know, how good we are, and just if we just keep on playing like that, I'm sure we'll be fine.
Where does this leave England in terms of qualification? They're in the driving seat now. Is this a real turning point, do you think?
Well, we're just going to keep on taking every game as it comes, not get too, you know, ahead of ourselves. Just, you know, next game and then the game after that. And if we, you know, obviously play like we did tonight, I'm thinking we'd be absolutely brilliant.
Yeah, many congratulations. Well played, sir. Well done.
The exuberance of youth there. What a stunning performance by him and by England. Fabio Capello said, "I'll be judged on the Croatia game." How do you judge that performance?
He's a football genius. I thought they were. I mean, they were brilliant with me tonight. They scored four. Arguably, Frank Lampard's goal should have counted as well. You know, in the second half, they're spreading balls across the pitch. Everyone was full of confidence. Everybody wanted the ball. And Croatia would have spent force, wouldn't they, after about 55 minutes? Once the sending off happens, you've seen the Croatians through in the towel, as Chris Waddle said.
As near perfect as you can get, Sam?
Yes, absolutely.
Half mark goal,
Yes. That's sloppy from the manager's point of view. You would point that out sometime, maybe.
But it could have been a free kick.
Yes, definitely. But, I mean, in the end, it hasn't mattered, that is. And taking the gloss off it. And for me, the old master's shown the apprentice. I think Slaven Bilic has been in his place tonight. And I think that Fabio Capello has got his team to show him what he wants. And I think they've played the English way. They've earned the right to play first. Before all the pretty football came out, they did the job, they closed the opposition down, they stopped the danger men, and then played their way into the game. And of course, the first goal was very, very important. Theo Walcott, absolutely brilliant. Started off a little bit nervous, and then the first goal goes in. I think he's taking his chances magnificently. Wayne Rooney scored. We've had 20, 30 passes towards the end. It's built the confidence up. Great result at this venue.
Terry, how shrewd do you think England and Fabio Capello have been tonight?
Well, the players have had it's been a long grind of criticism and hard work, and you know, and whatever happens, things have gone wrong and it just hasn't been right. And tonight, everything was perfect. Everything was perfect. Now, what you've got to get, and everyone keeps saying, well, we've lost our confidence, got to get confidence. Only one way you're going to really genuinely get that confidence is do what you've done tonight. And it releases everything else. Capello's had a top-class performance. The players themselves now feel so much better, and they don't want to worry about playing at Wembley because the fans will be thrilled. They won't be on their backs unless they slip back. But there's no need for them to slip back. This is what they want.
They think they can win the World Cup now on a performance like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, well, you've got to be steady for that. You've got to be steady about that, but don't let's spoil it tonight. No, I mean, just say it was magnificent, and all the players played, the team and the individuals together. The individuals were great, put themselves into a team play, and you wouldn't have wanted to play England tonight. The only one thing we've got to do is keep doing it.
There's nothing better than a brave decision by a manager or a coach than playing Theo Walcott, because we all thought he might go a little bit safe. Yeah.
Correct,
and play
correct,
David Beckham for the experience. And he's been, you know, an absolute threat to Croatia right from the very start, right to the very, very end. And he'll sleep better than anybody tonight, Fabio Capello, based on the way Theo Walcott has done tonight on a massive decision. Because if that had got wrong, and this result had gone wrong, Fabio would have been the first one to get it, you know, and it's happened the right way this time. And hopefully that'll be a spur for everybody, Agbong Lahore, Ashley Young, to try and break into this England side, because we need those young lads in there. What's happened to Sean Wright, Phillips, Aaron Lennon, people like that, all have to come and get back in this side, I think.
Even David Bentley, who wasn't even on the bench, a similar sort of name. Down that right-hand side, England could be looking good, but the man looking good tonight was Theo Walcott, outstanding.
Yeah, he was brilliant, wasn't he? And as Sam mentioned, the first 15 minutes, he was falling over the ball a little bit, and you just thought to yourself, you know, just have a little bit of composure. And then once the first goal goes in, he was involved in the disputed Emil Heskey penalty decision, and he just grew with a lot of confidence. And you see his third goal, he takes his third goal so well, doesn't he? You know, he knows he's on a hat-trick, he knows that no one's going to catch him because he's that quick. But this is his first goal.
And the first one, he says he wanted to be a bit more selfish.
Yeah.
He's capitalised on a mistake, a big mistake by the left back there, kicking it into his own defender. And there's not a better way to punish the opposition by doing this, and that's putting it in the back of the net.
Yeah.
He comes out from the back now, so, and he's still going. He could have ended up with something. He stops. He's that far up, Rio. He might as well keep going. As it happened, didn't need it.
But so England were adventurous from the start, weren't they?
Yeah,
they didn't sit back and wait what Croatia. They went and, you know, started expressing themselves straight away. But that came about, for me, the hard work in midfield from Gareth Barry, Frank Lampard shutting them down, winning the ball back from the front line, Mimir Leski. And that's where they got allowed so much possession.
The first whistle tonight, never at any stage, was really second best. from the whistle, and it just went bang, this is what we're going to do, and the fear went. The fear went out of it, and that's the only way you'll ever be great players.
He said play without fear,
well,
and that's exactly what they've done.
All managers say that, because, as I've said before, if you're frightened of dying, you won't enjoy living.
Yeah.
If you're frightened of playing and losing, you won't win, you won't enjoy it, and you won't do it. And that's what they've got tonight. Now, that's what they've got to retain, and that hunger of wanting more of it. Can't wait to get back with the England team, exactly. As opposed to saying, oh dear, you know, we've got this. That, it's true, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, and after a performance like that, you do want to rush back, don't you?
Well, the next game now will be full of confidence. We'll all be going in there talking about how we're going to win the group and how we should easily beat, you know, Belarus or whatever.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's important. But if we play like that, no one can stop us in our group if we play like that.
Was the sending off a sending off, gents? I mean,
I just think it was very aggressive, Kovac. Joe Cole's, 5'9", and Kovac's legs with his arm. I don't think there's any doubt of that. And he was very aggressive, and I can see why the referee sent him off, of course. You know, the blood pouring from his head straight away.
When he looked at him, Steve.
Yeah.
Once he's seen a gash like that, it sort of seemed to
did he frighten the referee in some way?
But is that the right decision then? Should he not be sending him off now? If he knows the challenge is that bad, it shouldn't be down to a cut head from Joe Cole being sent off. He should see that and say, he's hit him with his elbow. It was very, very aggressive.
He did blow straight away, didn't he? Of course, for the foul. And it was just a question of whether he thinks he's led with his elbow. And when you see it from that angle straight on, he comes right through him, doesn't he?
As hurtful as what his head was, because he's without fear himself. The centre half, he just goes right through.
That's what we don't understand.
And it's a powerful hit on his head.
He's got to run and jump on Joe Cole as well, Kovac. And of course, he's always going to outjump Joe Cole because of the size difference. But the fact that he's absolutely flattened him as well, I think he was premeditated. I think he knows that he's going to come right through Joe Cole.
Second goal, very similar to the first goal.
Yeah, another one, and it's great movement, this, isn't it? Rooney's in ball, Lampard, Heskey, dummy to shoot, and Theo, better connection than his first one, smashes it in. The goalkeeper is nowhere near the ball as well.
This time the movement and the passing and the build-up's much, much better. The first one came from mistake, but the goal's very similar.
But it shows that if it does come across the goal, you can see you've got Heskey there waiting for him to touch the ball down.
And he was excellent again, wasn't he? Heskey was excellent again.
Well, he makes the team function.
Everybody who plays with Heskey scores, you just feel sorry for Emil, the fact that he's not on the goal sheet himself, but you see Rooney's chipped in tonight. Whoever's partnered in Heskey invariably scores.
No, he's so good for the team, and you want him to get a goal because he needs. But he makes.
Do you think he needs
a difference?
A goal?
Well, he personally needs that goal.
Well.
Everybody else thinks. Don't worry about the goal.
Yes,
we'll do the goals. You just put them in there for us.
Which he did. And Wayne Rooney. How important do you think it was for Wayne Rooney on that second half performance, Sam, for him to score?
Oh, absolutely needed the goal at international level, not for club level. But certainly this one was well taken, well deserved on his second half performance, not just from Wayne Rooney but from the whole team.
I mean, great.
He finally finished off the opposition.
Great harrying by Ashley Cole, wasn't it?
Well, that's it, you see, winning the ball back in the opposition's half in the final third. One good pass, chance to score
a
goal.
Back of the net.
But it's so important that we've seen these games, and there's no sign of that, as you'd said earlier, about a good display. And this intangible thing that's between your ears makes all the difference, doesn't it? And all of a sudden we're doing things that, you know, we didn't think we would ever be capable of doing this again. And what a thrill, what a great, and the fans are still out there singing now. And I think they'll be, and you sound about
it. I think I'll be with them.
You said Fabio will sleep well tonight. If I know, manager, he won't be going to sleep at all.
let's get some more reaction from the England camp. Here's Wayne Rooney, he's with Dan.
Wayne, many congratulations. A performance to make the country proud again. How on earth did you do it?
Yeah, we've been, as we've said before, you know, the friendly games we've had before last week and tonight have all been a progress for us to improve and try and qualify for the World Cup. And I think tonight with a bit of, revenge in mind as well, it was a great performance by us and a great result.
But where did the performance come from? We hadn't seen any signs of that kind of display in the last few matches.
No, as I said, in the friendlies we've tried different things, and against Andorra, you know, it's always a difficult game to play against 11 men behind the ball, and you know, we knew tonight Croatia would come and be a really tough game for us, but as I said, I thought we defended really well and took our chances, which is the main thing.
What can you say about the impact, the contribution that Theo Walcott made? He was handed his big chance and goodness he took it.
Yeah, I think it was brilliant. You know, it just offers us something a bit different, you know. He's probably the quickest player I've seen, and You know, I think against Andorra he showed glimpses of what he can do in tonight. Three great goals, and I'm really pleased for him.
How big a player can Theo be for England in the future, do you think?
Yeah, he can be brilliant. You know, Svensson and the talent, and was brave enough to select him for the 2006 World Cup. And, you know, it's been a bit of a roller coaster for him the last 2 years. He hasn't always played for Arsenal, but hopefully, you know, after the last two performances, he can get a solid place in the Arsenal team before, you know, he makes a big impact for us.
You've had your fair share of criticism, Wayne, people saying that you don't play as well for England as you do for United, but tonight you enjoyed out there.
Yeah, of course, you always enjoy a 4-1 victory, and, you know, especially after what Croatia had done to us in the last qualifying campaign. You know, it was all the players are so pleased in there, and, you know, I'm sure all the fans are the same.
This is a result that will put the smile back on the faces of the fans. How pleased are you for them?
Yeah, of course, you know, we've seen the fans in Andorra and again tonight, they were brilliant. Lots of fans over here, and I think as the players, you know, the fans have waited a long time to see us give a performance like that, and, you know, we're all pleased we've done that for them.
As for Fabio Capello, does this prove, this result, that he is the man to turn England's fortunes around, do you think?
I hope so. You know, as a team, we've had a bit of criticism for our friendlies, as I said before, but as I said, the main thing what matters is the 3 points in tonight's game and, you know, the next few games. So, you know, hopefully we can take this form into the next games, you know, and that'll give us a good stead.
Ryan, well done tonight, sir. Thank you.
Fabio Capello has made his way back out into the stadium and has been applauded by all those England fans who are still inside here, inside the Maximir Stadium. They won't mind being kept in because they're still revelling in every moment of the 4-1 victory this evening. You talk about him sleeping well. He worked everything out to a T. They followed a game plan and every box was ticked, wasn't it?
Yeah. And we know the result in the end was a great result, but even in the first 20 minutes, as Terry said before, we were never under any pressure. I think the players knew within 20 minutes, we've got the better of these teams. They closed them down. They were second. They were onto the ball all the time. The likes of Modric and Petric were very low-key, didn't do much, and I think the players just grew in stature from then on.
I mean, you alluded to it, Sam. You know, Bilic said they were a better side. But, you know, before the game, we're a better side. We're confident. We're better than we were in the Euros. It certainly weren't that.
Well, it's breeded overconfidence from the managers to the players tonight, hasn't it? Like, I mean, you know, they've come in as favourites for the first time. England are the underdogs. We're going to be, you know, we're going to win a draw.
I wouldn't change any one of our players.
I wouldn't have an English.
But he would
know. all that sort of stuff's gone on, and it's obviously bred into complacency. Yeah. Instead of anxiety, and the complacency has now taken over, thinking they're going to go out there, get the ball, and we're going to pass England off the park and win. And England has done the complete reverse. They've earned the right. They've earned the right to play first. They've stopped the opposition on their own ground, and then they've gone and battered them tonight. Yeah. And never mind the ability. We all hear about the managers saying it's your determination, it's your confidence, it's your desire, it's your will to win, it's your team spirit. That's nothing to do with the talent you've got. We all know they've got talent. They need the mental set to put all those abilities into practice as an individual, as a team. You get a result like this.
Let's not get carried away. Okay, it's a great victory, but it's one victory. But it's building on that mentality and making it.
But imagine the reverse tonight if we'd lost that game. That's why it was an absolute must. Everything, every last section of your body that you can put into it, you had to do it, and they did that. But no waiting, no sparring. Boom! Straight into them, and they give them a shock, and they never recovered the whole game.
Mackie, you said it was a bit harsh that Frank Lampard goal was disallowed.
Yeah, I think Simonic makes the most of it, doesn't he? But this is the movement. We're knocking the ball around. So much confidence later on. I know it's easy to say that when we're so far up, but the movement's great, the passing's great. Great dummy by Lampard. You see Heskey there.
Doesn't deserve it. He's gone a couple of paces before he's gone down.
Yeah. Yeah. They were after everything in the end. Once they went down to 10 men, they were rolling around. Kovac was rolling around, wasn't he? Simonic was rolling around. And it was a pity because it was a great goal and it would have capped a great game off for Frank Lampard as well.
And a bit of dispute about their goal as well. And we alluded to that.
If that's a foul, it's a little bit of sloppy play from England, that ball. Look at this here. His foot's... I mean, John Terry's jumping for that and his foot's above his head, so if that's not dangerous play. But, you know, when this sort of thing happens to you, certainly at this level, certainly in Premiership, Terry's been at this level, you've got to make sure it doesn't hurt you. And this tonight, that mistake perhaps by the referee or by the team, it hasn't hurt them.
No.
It's won the 3-0 up. It's won the games evenly balanced. It could all, a great performance could be all turned against you in a split second, and it hasn't happened tonight.
No, damaged a bit of pride and nothing, and a bit on the goal difference, but nothing else. But of course, the man of the night, Theo Walcott, had to pick up his hat-trick, didn't he?
He's had a magnificent night. He must be pinching himself and think he's going to wake up, because it's a fairy story.
Yeah.
And to be honest, he done so well for the first 25 minutes against Andorra, but you say to yourself, can he do that again? And you think, you know he's going to, but it may be further down the line. And he's pitched into this, and you know he deserves everything
that's
coming to him.
I think it was brilliant from Rooney, plucking the ball out of the sky and then feeding them in. And as I said, Theo Walcott was not for catching, was he? He's got far too much pace. And it was just whether he has the composure. He was going onto his left foot, whether he had the composure to slip it past the goalkeeper, and thank God he did.
Okay, we're going to take another break. We have still plenty more reaction to come. From Zagreb, where celebrations are still going on, we'll be hearing from manager and captain next. To the Barclays Premier League on Friday night. We'll be previewing all the action and the Friday football show at 9:30 here on One. On Saturday night at 8, you can get the scores at 8, all the reaction to the Barclays Premier League action. And then on Monday night, 10:15, Football Matters with James Richardson and Rebecca Lowe. The last word on the weekend. Well, the England fans are still in the ground, but they have reason to be cheerful, still singing, still enjoying themselves. Right, let's hear from the England captain now. Here's John Terry.
John, many congratulations. One of the most incredible performances in English footballing history. What was the secret to that success?
I think our game plan was to go out there and not give anything away the first 10, 15 minutes and, you know, sit back and assess the game, which I thought we'd done. You know, clip balls in behind and turn them round and put a bit of pressure on them, which I thought we'd done as well. When, you know, we put them under a bit of pressure and they didn't seem to like it, so we continued doing that.
Croatia have never lost a competitive match here. Tonight, they were destroyed. What was the secret and how big a win do you think this is?
I think, as I say, we come into the game confident but not overconfident. Obviously, respecting them as a team and individuals and respecting their record at home. I mean, it's fantastic to hear the fans singing, and hopefully that victory and performance will get them behind us even more now.
Assess the impact, the contribution that Theo Walcott made, because he was handed a big chance here and he took it.
Yeah, he was. In the first 10, 15 minutes of the Andorra game, you know, he set the game alight and caused a lot of problems. And I think, you know, when he's on the team sheet, any defender will be petrified. And I think we see that from the left back tonight. So, you know, he gives us that outlet. He's great one-on-one. He's a great team player. Works very hard for the team defensively as well. You know, he's really given the manager, you know, food for thought now.
How big a future can Theo play in the future for England, do you think?
I think he's set the tone over these last two games, and you know, he's certainly given the manager a big problem now. If he continues playing like that, I'm sure he'll be in the team and, you know, keep going.
A word for the manager, Fabio Capello, because he made a brave call tonight. It's a positive formation and a big call to leave Becks out and to bring in Theo Walcott.
Yeah, it was, and credit to the manager for that. Credit to Theo for stepping up to the challenge. You know, he's still a young boy, but he's been awesome all week. You know, he's come in, he's not a shy boy. He gets involved and gets involved in the banter and the team. You know, I think that performance showed what he's all about tonight.
It was reminiscent of Michael Owen's display against Germany, the hat-trick, the first competitive hat-trick since Munich.
No, he was. He's got that pace and the excitement that the fans like to see. And when he gets the ball, you know, the fans get a lift, the players get a lift, and we want to get it to him as quick as possible. So if he can give us that outlet with the other side, with Coley and the likes of Wayne, the way he played tonight, I thought was awesome.
To what extent, John, does this go some way in making up for missing out on the Euro 2008 finals?
It does. I mean, we can't get carried away with ourselves, as I suggested in my press conference. You know, there's still an awful long way to go in this group. There's still a lot of points to be played for. You know, but let's enjoy the result and the performance, because tonight we played very well, you know, individually and collectively. We was awesome tonight.
It was physical out there, John. Did Kovac deserve to go, do you think?
I've not seen it, if I'm honest, so I can't really say, but I know Coley's got a very bad cut and it was really open, so you know, he must have caught him.
You're in the driving seat now in terms of qualifying. How large a step forward have England taken when it comes to qualifying for the World Cup?
I think we have, and this could be the stepping stone to really push us on there in this campaign. And we said that, you know, we needed that performance, let alone the result, you know, to get the fans back with us. I think we've done that tonight, and hopefully, you know, we can all push on and continue and qualify for the World Cup.
John, congratulations, you made us proud. Well done.
Well, one man leaving with his tail between his legs tonight, Slaven Bilic. It's all quiet in the Croatian camp. Their fans went home hours ago, it seems. In fact, at times, it seemed actually that they never really turned up. It is time not to get carried away, though, isn't it? Although you want confidence, but you don't want that overconfidence that Croatia have perhaps shown. Although you're going to think, you're going to go to Belarus and think, well, that's an easy game.
Well, let's hope we go to Belarus and play like that. We know that a couple of games ago against the Czech Republic, we were not very good. Andorra was very professional. Today, we were excellent. I think it's moving on from this and taking it into the next game. We know when we go to Eastern European games that they're going to be difficult, they're going to be hostile. And it's about being confident, about playing the right way. And if we repeat ourselves or get anywhere near how we play tonight, we'll turn the likes of Kazakhstan and Belarus over, no problem at all.
It's shown that Fabio Capello will set up his side the way he wants it for individual games. He said, look at Andorra as one, look at Croatia as another.
Yeah, I mean, it's fairly obvious. I mean, one's very low scale down the bottom, one's very high up. But I just thought the way that we went about this, I mean, it's not a matter of looking at this and we're knocking the ball about. It's not a matter of starting like we finished. It's starting how we started. Because we started tonight and at times we were pushed back and we decided to be sound, not give anything away. But as John said, we then went out and got at them, and then they realised that they didn't like it, so they give that to them more. They've got to start to make a big impact on the opposition, to knock their morale down so they don't want the ball, and make them make mistakes. And that's what they did tonight perfectly.
Sam, is that something that Capello has brought in that wasn't there when Steve McClaren was there, when Sven-Göran Eriksson was there? Is there a different mentality?
Well, I was a little worried when we sort of... Not that I take too many notice of friendlies, personally, as a manager. I think there's too much read into them. But we looked as if he was sort of trying to impose the Italian style of play on the English players. And for me, it doesn't suit. And I think that maybe along those friendly games, he's thinking, well, you know, how did he want to play? How did he like to play? What did he want to do? Because week in and week out, in the Premiership is what you saw tonight, earning the right to play, closing the opposition down from the front, denying them space to play the sort of game they want to play, and then taking full advantage of the opportunities and the possession you get, particularly in the opposition's half. And, you know, that's exactly how most Premiership games are played week in and week out now, with a high intensity and a quicker passing. And then when it became into England's favour, they started to relax, they started to enjoy the football. They put 20, 30, 40 passes and then even carved Croatia open. But the job that they did, like Terry says, from the start was the most important thing to carry on from here on, and then to get the job done as quickly as possible.
Okay, so the Italian has played it the English way and it's worked out perfectly. Masterminded to perfection. England 4-1 victors here in Zagreb. Let's hear from the animated England manager now. He's with Dan.
Fabio, congratulations. A night we'll never forget. What was the secret?
No, it's a secret is that we stayed 10 days together. I said yesterday, step by step, we will be better. We move on. And today we played with a lot of confidence, without fear. The first minute, to the hand, and we play very, very good team, a good game.
How proud are you of your players this evening?
Yes, the players played very well, and a little mistake only when they score the goal, but they play very well and like a team, and a lot of courage. Usually, England played away not to courage, but this time we played technically well, but with confidence and courage. It's very, very important.
You made a big decision to play Theo Walcott, and he repaid that faith. How pleased are you with his performance?
I think he's young. He's a dangerous player for the defenders. He's, in this moment, he's got a moment of form. And is a very, very, very happy for Theo, and happy also for Beckham, because you have to decide you have to choose one of two, and I choose Wild this time.
You mentioned David Beckham. Does he still have a future with England?
Yes, why not? When I choose the squad, I choose always the best player at the moment.
How important a player can Theo be in future years for England, do you think, given tonight's display?
Theo is one of the most important players in England, young players in England. I hope he's not injured because he's so fast, he's so dangerous.
Croatia had a player sent off when it was 1-0. How important was that, and should it have been a sending off? Did Kovac deserve to go, do you think?
Yeah, I think the referee decided well, because the tackle into her was very, very, very strong. And we scored goal, we played very well. But also before, we had a lot of chances to score goals.
Where did this performance come from? We saw a little sign of it in the friendlies that you oversaw, the game against Andorra, for example. Have they surprised even you this evening?
No. Not surprised, because I know the players. I know when what is possible to do during the game. I know very well all the players during the training. And we play today like in training. This is the secret. Play the same confidence, the same without fear. And I think this is the start.
Croatia had never lost a competitive match here. To beat them 4-1 here is an incredible performance, a massive achievement by England, isn't it?
The score is very, it's incredible, but the performance of the team is also very, very good. Okay, thank you.
Fabio, well done, sir. Thank you.
I think he ended the interview there. He's
still going to be in there, Dan, speaking to him.
I know, but you want to talk to him after that, because he is an intriguing character. What John Terry said before was that he had the aura of Jose Mourinho, and I wonder if that is now being spread across the England dressing room.
Let's hope so. I mean, I think it was important that they did stay on in Barcelona, didn't they? They had a couple of days more together, and he's worked wonders from them. I mean, considering the 2 games ago, they're playing 4-3-2-1 formations, and tonight it was just a typical 4-4-2. We knew what to expect, and they went out and got the results. So let's hope he is rubbing off, and game by game, his English will improve. So hopefully then, tactically, he'll be able to get his messages across to the players, and we onwards and upwards.
Mm. And Terry, he also pointed out, they've had 10 days together. You know, as an international manager, what that's like to actually have the players for a concerted period.
It's like gold dust, because you get 2 days, maximum three. Sometimes they're injured after or played the night before. You just don't get any time at all. So you've got to keep everything so simple, but on the button. And I think that's what they've done. And we did say after the Andorra game, this next few days is going to be important to him and what he can do. And he's proved he's done a lot.
Yeah, he's done it, hasn't he, Sam?
He has done it, and we just hope he goes from strength to strength from here now, because he's done it, not just him and his backroom staff, because he's got a big backroom staff now, really more than anybody else has had, I think. And that eventually will pay dividends, and I think then the players have got to know how he wants to work, he's got to know how they work, and that's all coming to fruition starting when it mattered, and that was Andorra. And now this game, and let's hope we can just go on from here.
Okay, thanks very much indeed, gents. Let's check on some of the other scores tonight. Belarus have beaten Andorra, 3 away wins in Group 6. That's England's group. Of course, the Ukraine have beaten Kazakhstan by 3-1. It leaves the table looking like this. Both England and Ukraine have a perfect record. And the good news for England fans is that you see Croatia in fourth place with just 3 points from that one game. And then in Group 9, that's Scotland's group, their first victory. They've beaten Iceland by 2-1. The Dutch also won tonight by the same scoreline against Macedonia. And that's the way the table looks in Group 9. The Netherlands on top with Macedonia, but both Macedonia and Scotland have played 2 matches each. Wales picked up defeats to go along with a victory that they had against Azerbaijan on Saturday. Unlucky they were beaten 2-1 in Russia. Finland and Germany shared 6 goals apiece, and Liechtenstein drew with Azerbaijan. So their table looks like. That's Germany on top, but they were held by Finland, so just 4 points from their two games there. Russia have 3 points, and Wales there with 3 points as well from their two games. Northern Ireland picked up a home point against the Czech Republic in a goalless draw. Poland have beaten San Marino by 2-0. Slovenia beat Slovakia by 2-1. And Poland on top, but no one has a perfect record. Poland and Slovenia have played two and picked up some 4 points. Slovakia are in third place. Northern Ireland with just that 1 point down in fifth, but at least they got their first point today. And finally, the Republic of Ireland, who drew at Montenegro today. It was a goalless draw there. Italy beat Georgia by 2-0. So that means the Group 8 table looks like this, with Italy with a perfect record so far. The Republic of Ireland in second place on 4 points. Well, our next football for you from Scotland is at Fir Park on Saturday at 11:30. That's Motherwell against the champions Celtic. That's on Setanta Sports 1 at 11:30. Then join us for our next action from the Barclays Premier League. That's Manchester City against Chelsea. What a tasty encounter that could be at Eastlands. Our results service will start at 4 o'clock with kickoff at 5:30 here on Setanta Sports 1. Then Tottenham is our next port of call on Monday night at 7. The visitors are Aston Villa. You may recall last year that was a 4-all thriller. And then on Thursday night, Tottenham in action again in Europe from 7:30, Setanta Sports 1. My thanks to my guests tonight. It's been great to have you here. And England have been walking in a Walcott wonderland. It's Slaven Bilic's birthday tomorrow, and England have just given him the biggest birthday bumps of his life. Bye-bye.
You have been chosen to be the bards of a poetry beyond words. Never forget those times as a boy to kick the football was all you wished to do. Pull on those boots and be that boy for us, for England. Fear nothing, for we stand alone together. We shall meet on the quest. Think of those voices as a sea of discontent smashing against rocks. But you are the commanders of the ships upon the ocean. You are our captains. Do not underestimate your powers. You have the tools born of years of training, skills, beauty. We look to you for guidance. We look to you for love. We look to you for beauty. Fear nothing.